Hi, I'm Joe, and this is Chris, and many of you know us. And we'd like to welcome you to our new showroom here at 618 North Reading Avenue in Boyertown, where we offer Kohler faucets, Moen faucets as well, vanities, tubs, and many accessories.
Here we have an operating, high-efficiency, Energy Star-rated American Standard furnace combined with a variable speed AC condenser. Let us install one today to start saving you money throughout the heating and cooling season.
Here at Patriot, we now offer kitchen and bath designs.
So come visit us today at 618 North Reading Avenue or visit our website at www.patriotmp.com.
Welcome to the beautiful historic Reading Country Club, now open to the public. Play the same course that Sneed, Hogan, and Hagen played. Designed back in 1923 by renowned golf architect Alex Finley, the Reading has 18 championship holes. Now, after your round, just stop on by the Patio Grill for delicious food and a nice ice-cold beverage. Why not book your organization's next outing at the Reading Country Club? Hey, and by the way, check out the weekly exciting leagues. It's memorable now at the Reading. For more information, just check out the website, readingccgolf.com.
This is the year you're going to improve your game. No excuses. And the pros at Blackwood Golf Academy are here to help. With their 23-acre all-grass driving range, full-service pro shop, and computerized swing analysis, Blackwood Golf Academy will get your game up to par. Need lessons? Individual and group instruction with head pro Chris Carr will shave strokes off your game and make you the envy of your next foursome. Blackwood Golf Academy, a country club setting open to the public, adjacent to Blackwood Golf Course in Douglasville.
Butter Valley Golf Course, conveniently located in the quiet, rural setting of Valley, PA, just off Route 100. One of the nicest, most affordable 18-hole course in the region. With changing elevations, challenging greens, and scenic fairways, golfers of all ability levels are sure to enjoy their round. Butter Valley Golf Course is a great place to enjoy the game of golf with friends or family, young and old alike. Grab some buddies and grab a meal at the Runway Grill before or after your round. Butter Valley Golf Course.
So, car stories on PCTV. I've been doing it for many years. It's a good advertising tool for the business. Plus, I enjoy doing it. I enjoy sharing the shop and the different things that you should know about your car with people. If you need a place to highlight your business, call Gus at PCTV and check it out. It's a good way to inform people about your business. You'll get new customers from it, and you can share your knowledge of your particular trade.
Butter Valley Golf Course, conveniently located in the quiet, rural setting of Valley, PA, just off Route 100. One of the nicest, most affordable 18-hole course in the region. With changing elevations, challenging greens, and scenic fairways, golfers of all ability levels are sure to enjoy their round. Butter Valley Golf Course is a great place to enjoy the game of golf with friends or family, young and old alike. Grab some buddies and grab a meal at the Runway Grill before or after your round. Butter Valley Golf Course.
One day these rats were playing in the woods.
One of some rats just said, that's no good.
Yow! So if a gorgeous force is what you decide, don't play with matches,
don't play with fire. Yeah.
Only you can prevent forest fires.
Fire!
We're going to need some help from younger guys on the defensive side. There's some guys at wide receiver that haven't played before that are now coming out again. And that we feel can have a huge impact on our season, but it's all that's got to fall into place. So, you know, if something happens tomorrow where, you know, unfortunately someone gets hurt or something like that, then we got to make adjustments on the fly, because our numbers are up this year. We're in the 70-75 range, but in terms of depth, you know, there's only so many of those kids that are close to being ready to play at a varsity level. So, you know, you need that. You need the large roster, and you need the kids returning to provide the depth.
I mean, honestly, from my perspective, our defense is what has won us the last two league championships. We play a system that is becoming a little bit more common, but I don't think people see it too often in our 3-3 stack. So, you know, that presents a challenge, I think. And our defensive coordinator, Matt Young, and our defensive line coach, Tim Conley, I can't say enough about them. They're just outstanding football coaches. They have great rapport with our defense, and they set the tone for those 11. You know, we're going to get to the football in a bad humor.
The following sports presentation is brought to you by the PCTV Network, powered by TELUS Vision, your hometown station. We're home for you.
It's Earth's Little Heaven, the PCTV Network. PCTV Network, your hometown station. We're home for you. That's our slogan. But I dare adjust, and it's the truth, and it fits best. The PCTV Network, your number one source for local sports, with your favorite hosts, Bernie, Dave, Al, and Scott. The PCTV Network, we're home for you. It's more than a slogan, it's all true. Local programming, stream 24/7. The PCTV Network, it's Earth's Little Heaven. The PCTV Network, check out channels 22, 28, and 98. Tune in, it's sure to be great. ThePCTVNetwork.com, 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 Make sure you support PCTV Network, PCTVNetwork.com, your hometown station.
Stadium at Springfort Area Senior High School. The PCTV Network Sports presents Pioneer Athletic Conference Football. Tonight is for the Liberty Division Championship, Park Valley versus Springfort. Good evening, everyone. This is Dave Ridenour, joined by Scott Furman. And Scott, every year there's that one special game where, as an old player and as an old coach, you feel like going down there and suiting it up again. If tonight isn't a night, you can't get jacked up at all.
And David, this atmosphere doesn't fire you up. This is high school football. And you and I were just saying earlier, this is the way high school football was meant to be.
You wish it was this way every Friday night. Well, let's go to the visitors first, the two-time defending champion, Park Valley Vikings, your old squad. Cole Peterton really is the guy that makes this thing go.
And there's no doubt about that, Dave. Their offense and their whole team is going to go as Cole Peterton goes. You know, look at him. He leads rushing, passing, and a couple weeks ago they brought him in, he got a game-winning touchdown. So as he goes tonight, it's going to be important. But Dave, also, I think Coach Heist, that preseason schedule was meant for tonight. Those Downingtowns East, the Downingtown West, he prepared his team to be in this situation for tonight against this type of competition.
Well, on the home sideline, obviously Ryan Ingro has really opened a lot of eyes. A lot of people didn't know much about him coming into the year. He is only a junior in his first full season as a quarterback, but boy, he has really opened some eyeballs.
And you're right. You know, you talk about Benani, Scarcelli, Baker, Britt. He spreads the ball around, and I truly feel if Springfort keeps him upright tonight, and he's on tonight throwing, it's going to be a long night for Park Valley.
Well, you know, sometimes the defenses get overlooked in these two squads because of their offensive proficiency. I think defense is going to have a lot to do with the game tonight.
And you're right. You know, you look at Springfort, only 92 yards rushing, PV only 109. So something has to give here tonight with these defenses. But, Dave, again, they're going to be aggressive tonight. I think it may be a high-scoring game tonight because I think both teams are going to come out offensively and try to light up the scoreboard.
Well, it's going to be a good one. Settle back in your easy chairs and watch as Park Valley and Springfort get ready to lock horns.
Welcome to the beautiful historic Redding Country Club, now open to the public. Play the same course that Sneed, Hogan, and Hagen played.
Designed back in 1923 by renowned golf architect Alex Finlay, the Redding has 18 championship holes. Now, after your round, just stop on by the Patio Grill for delicious food and a nice ice-cold beverage. Why not book your organization's next outing at the Redding Country Club? Hey, and by the way, check out the weekly exciting leagues. It's memorable now at the Redding. For more information, just check out the website, RedingCCGolf.com.
For more than 50 years, Pottstown Oral and Maxillofacial Surgery has served its community with expert dental care, offering patients dental implants and a full menu of procedures for many types of dental problems, including bone grafting, wisdom teeth, impacted canines, facial trauma, jaw surgery, oral pathology, TMJ disorders, and sleep apnea. Get the smile you've always wanted. Contact Pottstown Oral and Maxillofacial Surgery today.
Hey, Terry Musser here. Doing whatever it takes as always. People ask me, can I still do a cartwheel? I can. But when we work with you, we're not only going to do cartwheels, we're going to bend over backwards.
Job by the Spring Ford Band as they get everybody all jacked up with their school alma mater and the Star Spangled Banner. You get a good look at Spring Ford's bench there. Remember, they will be in the all blue. Park Valley is in the white tops with the orange trousers and helmets. Again, they will be kicking off to the Rams. The Rams come in at 7-1 and 4-0 in the division. And PV's at 6-2 and 4-0. PV on a six-game win streak. There you see the standings for the Liberty Division. The two top teams, the winner of this ballgame, will play Pottsgrove next week at Pottsgrove for the Pioneer Athletic Conference Championship. And there is the Frontier. Pottsgrove has already clinched their division. As the Vikings get up in a pretty neat little formation here as they get ready to kick off to the Rams. As we mentioned in our pregame, if you can't get fired up for this one, you shouldn't be involved in high school sports. Both sidelines are playing, the kids and the student body and the bands, and this is just an awesome atmosphere. And there's the kickoff inside the 10-yard line. As Spring Ford will bring it out, looks for room to run. And he will be tackled in around the 25, 26 yard line where Spring Ford will take over.
All the way out to the 25 yard line, 27 yard line. Rams are set first and 10.
First and 10 from the 27 yard line. Ryan Engro, keep your eye on him. He has really grown into be a heck of a quarterback. Wears number 7, only a junior. He has thrown for 1,700 yards already this season. They start out in the spread. A lot of receivers, a lot of looks inside. And there to go right up the middle on first down and pick up a nice game. Looks like Stephen Brill wears number 20 for Spring Ford. As Spring Ford's going to go tempo here now a little bit, as they're going to run it up quickly, try to catch PV not ready on defense. There's the same play inside to Brill. Brill coming off a big game where he gained 125 yards last week. He is averaging a little over 5.5 yards per carry. Third and 4 for Spring Ford here. We'll see if Coach Brubaker likes to go to the air. They said Engro has thrown for 1,700 yards. He's put it up almost 200 times already here early in the season. Long count. And Engro's going to keep it on the run pass option, and he picks up the first down of the ball game as Engro reads that play, and Engro picks up the first down. As Springford goes no huddle again, they're running up tempo here. First and 10, ball is now on the 39-yard line. Long count. It's our first pass attempt. They got that out here. It looks like Scarcelli. Is that a catch and a fumble? Is that an incompletion? Is that a pass and a catch? As the referees are looking at each other there. Oh, they're going to call an incomplete pass there as Chad Brubaker was the extra official there as he comes out from his coaching box to help sway the referee's mind there. That was tough to tell whether that was a catch and he took a step or two or not. That was Blaze Scarcelli. Second and 10. Empty backfield. Uh-oh, they got a seam route going down the middle there as they tried to find Stephen Brill, but Brill was pretty well covered on the play. That was number 39, Lominaco. Lominaco back there on the coverage. Scotty, check it out. See if we got you, buddy. Again, we're having some problems with Scott Furman's microphone, gang, so hang in there with us. First real big play of the ball game here. We got a third and 10. As they go empty, they're going to go five wide, and we'll see what they do here. Engro looks. He's going to take it down. He's going to try to get it himself, but a good job of conversion defensively. That looked like number 56, Jake Sterling. We'll see what they do here on fourth and long. Is this a situation where they're going to punt it or are they going to try to go for it? Looks like they might go, or they're going to go with a pooch. We'll see if Engro elects to pooch this one. Yep, they're going to pooch it, try to catch him with nobody back there and pin him inside as that ball will bounce out at about the 22-yard line. We're going to take a quick timeout as PV will take over first and 10 from their own in 21.
An orthopedic institute is more than a name. It's a unique care model based on quality and compassion. Decades devoted to research and clinical trials, the development of new surgical techniques, and physicians who outperform the field. What you get from our institute is more options and more answers. For your orthopedic care, think Rothman first.
New office and 7-day urgent care now open in Limerick.
Austin Rowley on the first carry of the ball game with a nice pickup on first down. Orkfritz Robinson in on the tackle. He wears number 88 for the Rams. This is a good situation here. Now second and relatively short. That's Peterton calling out the signals. He fakes inside and passes to the outside. That looks like Doherty, number 15. They're going to pick up the first down for PV. This is a simple little out route, a little stop route. And PV picks up a first down as Doherty showing good hands there. But that was all set up by the first down play where they picked up 8 yards on the run by Rowley. Going to be a quick pitch outside. They're trying to get to the corner, trying to set the edge. And a good run by John Moshe. Moshe showed good speed as he tried to get to the outside. And another good productive play on first down. This is like sort of like an old quick pitch outside to Moshe. And Moshe does a real nice job of getting outside, picking up 5 yards. Again, PV going no huddle. They're going up-tempo as well, trying to keep Springford from being able to substitute defensively. They're going to go inside. Oh, and a good hard run up the gut. That looks like Jake Sturm, number 33. That name sounds familiar. Everybody remembers his brother, Steve, who was a heck of a quarterback, a record-setting quarterback at Perky Oman Valley. Third and one now for the Vikings. Again, Dave Ridenour, Scott Furman. Unfortunately, Scott's microphone is not working well yet, so we're still continuing to work on that. But we're down here at the McNelly Stadium in Springford for this championship game between the undefeated Rams and the undefeated Vikings. Back to the ground. Looks like Moshe with another first down as Perk Valley gets a good surge off their offensive line.
Gets the first down, tackle on the play by Walter Malicious.
We're going to get another look at it inside. And as the big guy, Walter Malicious, the big defensive tackle, all 6'7 and 295 pounds, which is legit, by the way, as I stood beside him before the game. He is a monster. Keep your eye on number 64. And there's Peterman with the keep. And you see why he is the leading ball carrier for the Vikings. He comes into the ball game with just over 350 yards. Last year, he gained almost 1,000 yards on the ground for the Vikings. Right now, let's give a little credit to the offensive line for PV. As I look over to Scott, he nods his head as they are getting off the ball. That's Peterton in the set all by himself back there as he rolls to his right. Can't find the receiver, and he's going to skirt outside to try to get out bounds after a short pickup. Noah Baker pushes him out of bounds after a pickup of 3. Noah Baker is certainly one of those pleasant surprises for Coach Brubaker. He had been a basketball player, and Coach Brubaker got him to come out for football. He certainly has made a difference here in the gridiron this fall. Second and 7, all set eye. Want to give it straight up inside. It looks like Sturm again, as Sturm twists and turns close to the first down marker.
Sturm with the carry. Tackled by Ryan Cullender.
Cullender on the tackle for Spring Ford. He's 6'4 and 200 pounder. He's a big old DND tackle. There's a timeout on the field. It looks like we have an injured Viking. That looks like number 64, Matt Wilhelm.
What?
There's a place for wood in your backyard. We recommend the fire pit. For looks and performance that outlast a wooden deck, make sure your next deck is built with Trex. Engineering what's next in outdoor living.
Your Trex expert is A.D. Moyer Lumber. ADMoyer.com.
Well, we're hoping old Matt Wilhelm is going to be okay. He's a junior. They need his depth and his work on that offensive line. Third and short for a PV. They are inside Springford territory as they closing in on the 30-yard line. There's a ball handoff to Moshe as he tries to get outside, and a good solid play out on the outside corner by Springford. That's Stephen Brill, number 20, who doubles as a defensive back. Another first down, though, for PV as they pick up their third first down here early in the first quarter. 6:33 to go as Moshe was bumped out of bounds, so the clock will stop. PV will take over inside their 30 at the 29 now on first down as Peterton fakes the toss, gets to the outside, gets down that left sideline and picks up another big gain. Nick Yuba stops it before he can get into the end zone. I tell you, they need this guy to play well for them to win tonight, and he had been nicked up most of the season, but you could see the skill and what he brings to the table offensively. And PV picks up its fourth first down of this drive. Very impressive here in their opening drive of the first half. Just outside the 10-yard line, or excuse me, the 15-yard line. Peterton looks, he's a lefty. He rolls that way, reverses his field. Tries to throw one deep into the end zone, it's up in the air. Oh, and it falls incomplete. Well, the old scramble play, you know, they are a team that really works hard on these broken plays. Isaiah Domini is a guy that really can come down with these big catches. That time it looked like Austin Rowley, number 23, went up there and almost came down with the catch. Give Peterton a little credit there for avoiding the sack, as Springford did a good job of pressuring the left-handed quarterback. Second and 10 from the 15. Peterton all by himself in the backfield there. Empty set. And there's our first whistle of the ball game. Let's see what we got here.
Delay of game.
Delay of game.
Offense. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
PV was a little slow getting that play off. You know, we had talked about this in many of our telecasts. They do have the shot clock there, if you will. And so they should be able to see that. Cole Peterton is sort of real slow on the draw. So that'll be our first penalty of the night. That'll be a 5-yarder against the Vikings. Again, another empty set for PV. Uh-oh. Look at Peterton doing a heck of a job avoiding the traffic. He cuts it back in as he dives close to the end zone, but there's a penalty marker on the play. That looked like it could be a block in the back. From the end zone, look at the elusiveness.
Oh, Peterton. They said they weren't sure if he was going to get a
penalty. There you can see the play. I don't know what they called there, but it looked like it could be a block in the back.
Looked like they caught a hold there, Dave, on that one.
Holding on the offense. 10 yards from the spot of the foul. Second down.
Well, PV really had done a nice job in this initial drive, Scott, as they marched all the way down the field, 4 first downs. But now they're going backwards with a delay game and now a holding call.
Could be costly. When you get in the red zone, you got to make it pay.
Second and about a mile here now for the Vikings. Peterton barking out the signals. They're going to throw a little pass out here to Moshe. Moshe's got room to run on the outside. He picks up a block on the corner and gets near the 5-yard line. We'll see if that's enough for a first down or not.
And all that was, Dave, a swing pass. All that was a swing pass, and it would have been a fumble if that ball was on the ground. But again, get Moshe out in open space and look what he can do with the football. Great downfield blocking also by Perk Valley receivers.
Well, you know, normally when you see a long run, a wide receiver at least gets a screen on somebody. You know, they don't have to knock him over, screen him up.
Yeah, that's required of his receivers. You've got to be able to block.
Well, now they have it in the third and manageable now. You know, that's that old extended handoff anymore. Now try to get it out in space with your playmakers. And Moshe turned on the jets and picked up 18. More conventional now as they go under center. There's a pass out to the outside to Domini, and the ref says no, it hit the ground. Domini thought he got his hands underneath it. Let's check it out.
And all this was a naked bootleg out to the left here. It looked like it skipped.
Well, we can't see from that angle.
Yeah, here's another angle. Oh, I don't know about that one.
Well, they're going to go for it here early on. Rob Heist rolling the dice here. 4th and 3. Now they're going to check it out. They want to see what Spring Ford's doing defensively. Looks like they're manning up on the outside. We'll see what they can dial up. There's down to 4 seconds. They're going to have to call a timeout here to avoid another delay of game, and that's what Rob Heist does as he walks out on the field. Well, needless to say, a crucial, crucial timeout here as both coaches get an opportunity to talk to the teams. We're going to take a timeout. Still no score.
There's a place for wood in your backyard. We recommend the fire pit. For looks and performance that outlast a wooden deck, make sure your next deck is built with Trex. Engineering what's next in outdoor living.
Your Trex expert is A.D. Moyer Lumber. ADMoyer.com.
Well, Scotty, you know, you and I love the coaching in these big games and crucial, crucial fourth and three. What do you do here?
Peterlin, you're going to put in his hands. I think give him a run-pass option. Get him out on perimeter. Hey, if you don't like what you see, run it. If you like what you see, throw it.
Domini was still sort of pleading his case.
Yeah. And you know what, Dave? I might have questioned that one. I might have looked at that one again.
Here it is. Fourth and three. Bad snap. Uh-oh. There's a toss outside to Moshe. Moshe tries to avoid a tackler.
He got a first down.
He got a first down.
I think his spin, Dave, his little spin got him there.
That was a heck of a play. Individual effort by Moshe.
And all this was, you're right, Moshe's back. He's thrown out to the flats. Moshe's got to make the first down here. Three defenders out there on him, and I think the spin got him the first down.
Well, I'll tell you what, that was a heck of a play by John Moshe. And give Rob Heist credit for having the guts to make that play on a fourth
throw
and three.
Throw that ball. That's right. You're right, Dave. Yep.
That tells you the confidence he has in his quarterback. Boy, Spring Ford on a jailbreak there, and Peterton is lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage.
And that's one thing. You don't see Spring Ford blitz a lot. When they blitz, you know, they're sending the house. They like to read and react type of defense.
Romano in on the stop for the Rams. This will create a second and three. Or second and goal, I guess, from the three is what I should say. I apologize there for the Vikings. As you can see, everybody looking over to their offensive coaches to see what they want to call. As the clock continues to move, it's under 10 seconds here. They're going to have to hurry up as Peterton goes up under center. They got it off just in time. Oh, another good defensive play.
Well defended.
Wow, defense.
I think
that's the big boy, Mullis. Yeah,
Mullis. Dave, I think he had a quick screen out to his right set up and couldn't get the ball there. It was well defended by Springford.
Boy, give Jimmy Mick Jr. and Steve Schein and all the guys from Springford a lot of credit as they had that one very well defense. Setting up another third and goal situation from about the three, maybe the four.
But Dave, I'm going back to you. Don't let the clock run down that much. You got to give yourself a chance with the clock.
There's Peterton. He wants to do it himself. And look at Springford. Wow. There's that underrated defense that we talked about.
He should have pitched, Dave. That ball should have been pitched. And right here, he had the man open. I think he was a little afraid because he saw a guy upfield on him and was afraid to pitch that ball.
Del Romano looked like number eight in on that play. Heck of a job, the senior outside linebacker. Now they do have to kick the ball. Boy, that's got to be a win for Spring Ford at this situation.
I think so defensively, I'd be happy.
Even if it doesn't go through or goes through or doesn't, as Braden Basile or Basile gets the first points of the ball game, but give Spring Ford's defense a lot of credit as they stood tall inside the 5-yard line. We're going to take a quick timeout, and when we come back, it's 3-0 PV.
For more than 50 years, Pottstown Oral and Maxillofacial Surgery has served its community with expert dental care, offering patients dental implants and a full menu of procedures for many types of dental problems, including bone grafting, wisdom teeth, impacted canines, facial trauma, jaw surgery, oral pathology, TMJ disorders, and sleep apnea. Get the smile you've always wanted. Contact Pottstown Oral and Maxillofacial Surgery today.
Well, Braden Bassel draws first blood as PV gets on the scoreboard first. But again, Scott, I think Springford have to feel pretty good about that goal line stand.
And I would too, Dave. Again, they were down there first and goal, and you only gave them 3 points. And you're right, come away with the victory there. Yeah, that's what you pump your defense up about.
And PV really didn't even gain a yard. There's the kickoff deep inside the 10-yard line as he breaks it out to the outside. And again, good coverage. Let's see if Springford can answer now. We got a heavyweight fight out there. It's got to be a punch
and
a counterpunch.
Just be patient tonight. Don't get panic about the situation.
Don't forget, next week we'll be showing the championship game, which will be at Putchgrove High School. All the Frontier Division teams will be hosting the crossover game. And it'll be the winner of this ball game against the Falcons next Friday night. There's a quick pull and go, but that ball is a little bit low as they try to find inside Nick Teets inside.
Again, it's quick slide. All it was a quick slide inside. The guy inside, Malik Smith. Engro's got to get the ball there.
Well, Engro is completing about 56% of his passes this year. He's got a great touchdown to interception ratio, 22 TDs for only two INTs.
And that tells you a quarterback that makes good decisions.
Yeah, he was a former Monday morning quarterback player of the week. What a nice kid. There he gets some quick pressure as he gets outside and tries to pick up some yards. But really a good job by PV. That was Quadir Shedrick in there with a quick one.
Quadir was in there. I mean, Shedrick was in there. I thought he had him for a sack, Dave, but that shows you how elusive Engro is. You've got to bring him down. You've got to make a short tackle on him.
Lingo did a real nice job of pushing him out of bounds there. He is a senior, 6'1", 190-pounder. And again, another crucial third down for the Rams. Staying in the spread. Engro fakes inside. There's that slant route again. And I think he's got enough for a first down on a real nice
close,
play.
He's close, Dave. You're right. He's close. And again, it's just a fake to the handoff, inside handoff, and an inside slant with the inside man.
And a big first down for the Rams.
Springford needed this. They needed this first down to keep themselves moving.
Well, Teets is this young sophomore. He's only 5'6", 140 pounds, but you got to have guts to come across the middle to make plays like that. There's the play inside. Again, Engro will keep it around his left side, but good defense that time, led by Jake Stierling. Stierling is a junior. He's one of their leading tacklers.
Yep. Jake has done a great job for him all year.
Gaining a yard on the play brought down by a host of Vikings defenders.
And, Dave, we talk about Engro throwing the ball. He can run the ball so effectively also. You got, like Peterlin, you got to be defending him running past.
Brill is the leading ball carrier for the Springford squad. He comes in with 344 yards. Uh-oh. Coach Brubaker needs a timeout there. There's a little confusion on that play.
Timeout.
While there's a timeout on the field, we're going to take one as well with PV up by three.
Limerick Bowl is the area's ultimate family entertainment center, your league bowling headquarters for all ages and all abilities. Come in anytime and enjoy daily specials or experience our weekend glow bowling. Celebrate your next birthday at Limerick Bowl with the area's most affordable party packages, now including our newly renovated Family Fun Arcade. Limerick Bowl on West Ridge Pike. Get more information about upcoming leagues, tournaments, and open bowling specials online at limerickbowl.com.
Second and nine for Springford. Again, Dave Reidenauer, Scott Furman. We got Scotty back. We're going to keep our fingers crossed that everybody is good and the plug doesn't pop out again or something. Down here at the Coach McNally Stadium for the Liberty Division Championship game. That's Engro in the backfield. He wears number 7. He's the quarterback. He's going to keep it on a quarterback run. Picks up some good yards. Runs into his own man. and he is stopped about a yard or two short of the first down. Looked like Hunter Ritchie, number 27, with the tackle. It is third and one. I'm sure this is four down territory for Chad Brubaker. He's a gambler. He likes to roll the dice. Yeah, absolutely. Yep. Yep, little quarterback draw, if you will. That's a nice play. Let all the defenders go deep and then boom, quarterback draw. Springford comes into this ball game ranked number 6 in District 1 as far as the District 1 playoffs goes. PV is number 9, and there's a pass, whoa man, into all kinds of traffic, and that's going to be picked off. That's going to be picked off. That looks like Randy Washington, number 25, came up with the play as Engro threw in the double and triple coverage. Wow, what a play by Washington.
He's been doing a great job for them all year in the corner. And that was a great play he just came up with.
Well, it looked like there was two receivers in the same area.
Same area.
Had to be a little confusion.
And the ball was in the air.
Yes.
Popped up
yep.
in the air. A bounce of the ball, David.
Well, we just mentioned the fact that Engro has only thrown two interceptions all year. Now he throws his third in this crucial championship ball game. But a real nice play by number 25, Washington. Uh-oh. Okay, something's going on here.
That's Coach Brewer's second time out of this half.
Well, while they try to get things figured out on the field, we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, it's PV3 and Spring 4 nothing.
Yakalak Construction, serving the Tri-County area since 1946. Family-owned, free estimates, all types of concrete work, sidewalks, foundations, steps, curbs, and more. Professional service and quality. Give them a call, 610-323-8134.
Well, we talked about the officiating in games and getting yourself into position. And, you know, we got the side judge here right in front of Springford's bench. Having a hard game so far. He's had some tough calls he's got to get up there and make. He's looking around for help from some of his buddies.
And they're lucky if I can admire them. Look for help.
Yes. Yep. Well, we'll start over again at first down. This time he's going to throw the ball. He's going to go deep. He's got a man. But that's good coverage out there by Spring Ford. That's Nick Yuba. Nick Yuba was running stride for stride. That's Mike Dougherty, who was the intended receiver. He's only a junior. It looks like Springford is really doing a job trying to contain Isaiah Domini. I mean, they may be doubling him and doing some stuff. Yeah. Yeah. Try to help out with him. There's a fake inside the motion. They like the screen game. There's Austin Rowley. Oh, what a nice play. Great individual effort by Spring Ford. That is James Albert, one of the leading interceptors in the league. Yeah. And I'll tell you what, had Albert not been there, that was going to go for a big time. Well, it looks like they're going to let the clock run out here for quarter number one, and we're going to switch ends. So after the end of one, it is 3-0.
Hi, I'm Joe, and this is Chris, and many of you know us. And we'd like to welcome you to our new showroom here at 618 North Reading Avenue in Boyertown, where we offer Kohler faucets, Moen faucets as well, vanities, tubs, and many accessories.
Here we have an operating, high-efficiency, Energy Star-rated American Standard furnace combined with a variable speed AC condenser. Let us install one today to start saving you money throughout the heating and cooling season.
Here at Patriot, we now offer kitchen and bath designs.
So come visit us today at 618 North Reading Avenue or visit our website at www.patriotmp.com.
One day these rats were playing in the woods.
Wanted some matches and that's no good.
Ow!
Don't play with matches, don't play with fire.
Fire!
Sort of gorgeous force is what you desire. Don't play with matches,
don't play with fire.
Only you can prevent forest fires.
Fire!
Boy, James Albert with another big play. That was two back-to-back plays in that defensive sequence as he rushed Peterton before he had an opportunity to set his feet and cause that incompletion on fourth and three, as they did have an open receiver out there in the flat. BV will have to punt for the first time here in this game. That's Isaiah Domini as that ball's end over end. As it bounds down inside the 20-yard line, it's going to roll to about the 15, maybe the 14. It wasn't pretty, but effective.
At Superior Credit Union, we believe in growing stronger together. So we provide products and services to fit your financial needs and accommodate your busy lifestyle. With convenient services like home banking, e-deposits, account alerts, and a free coin counter for members, come see why Superior Credit Union is growing. Visit any one of our three locations in Collegeville, Royers Ford, and our brand new location in Pottstown. Superior Credit Union.
Well, let's see what they can do here now as they take the start over in the shadows of their goalpost inside their own 20-yard line. Engro back in the spread. He's going to go back to throw it again. Wow, there's a nice play. They got Baker. Baker down the seam route, and what a nice play on first down. Well, you know, you, when you're a quarterback, you got to have a short memory. He threw a pick the last throw. This time he finds Baker right down the seam. I'll tell you what, I love those basketball guys that say, no, I'm going to Duke. I can't play football. He goes out for football, and he has made a difference in this program. I look like Blaine Scarcelli with a nice catch, lowers his shoulder, picks up an extra yard. Well, we saw his brother have a great career here at Springford. Springford looks like they're a little upset there after that last pick, as they've come out offensively here and really, really look sharp. Well, Chad Brubaker trying to find his groove offensively here. Straight back. Uh-oh. Something happened here. Might have been a false start on all sides. Who knows?
Dead ball. False start.
Yeah. Sometimes
offense.
That happens, Scott. You
5-yard penalty.
Rolling
first
there.
Down.
Yep. Well, this has really been a pretty much of a penalty-free first half so far. Tap on wood.
I've been watching those games and helping these teams respect each other. They know how hard both this game's going to be.
Well, this rivalry has been set up for years. As I mentioned, I never knew how big the rivalry was until my sons went to Springford, and I found out about it. But this is a heck of a series between these two schools. Here's Engro again with a bullet. And Domini almost got that one-handed interception.
Ball for inside position there. He cannot let the receiver get inside him. So that's all timing. That's a timing pattern. You have to keep that guy in a spot and intercept that.
Well, Domini is one of those guys that play both ways for Robbie Heisen. He is certainly a dynamic player on both sides of the ball. Second down in about 15 now. We'll see what Springford elects to do. Is PV's moving around a little bit defensively, trying to confuse him. He rolls to the right. Tried to fire a bullet down that outside line, and that falls incomplete to set up a third and long. I'll tell you what, as a former quarterback, you run fast when you're scared. When you're getting chased and you're scared, you run fast, guy. Well, we'll see what Chad Brubaker can dial up here on third and 15. And I'm sure all the defensive coaches from PV are countering, you know. We got ourselves a pretty good chess match going on right now with 10:27 to go in the first half. PV's up by three. They're going to try to blitz him right up the
middle.
Yeah! Oh, nice play inside for PV. That is Brett Kukin.
Yep.
Kukin really did a good job of getting the pressure.
And that was a nice shot. He didn't have any time there. Angler got back and did. He didn't even have time to set his feet. But here we go. Hurry up. They're going to go for it, and they're probably going to punt it.
Well, we'll see. They pooched it one time. We'll see if they do it again. Angler is a – yep. He's in that pooch formation. Yeah, Chad Brubaker has done this many times over the years. As that ball is going to roll inside the 10-yard line, well, we'll be first and 10 when we come back from a timeout. It's still 3-0 Vikings.
When did you see the sign?
When I needed to jumpstart sales.
Build attendance for an event.
Help people find their way. Fast Signs designed new directional signage.
And got them back on track. Get started at fastsigns.com.
PV takes over first and 10 inside the 10-yard line. That's a real nice pooch kick that time by Angro, showing a lot more of his versatility. And remember Randall Cunningham used to do kick a lot for.
And you know, we had two times now that they'd start deep in their own end.
What a great fake by Peterton as everybody jumped on the fake man, the runner. And Peterton picks up a couple tough yards inside. As Springford's D is really tightening up on the interior. Scott, I want you to tell me about this big number 64 guy, Walter Malicious, 6'7", 295. You and I were standing beside him down there. He's a monster.
I looked up to him. I'll tell you that. He's a big boy, and you got to put double team in to get to him.
There's that quick pitch outside to Moshe again as he tries to get the corner.
Nice job by Springford to defend it at that time. He couldn't get to the perimeter. And again, string it out. Springford players, again, just string the play down out the sidelines and let your defenders get to the ball carrier.
Yeah, use that sideline as your 12th defender and string it on out. And well, I tell you what, this is a pretty big third down play deep in your own end. You know, Coach Heist certainly wants to try to get at least the first down here to give his punter some room. We know the Springford coaches, the defensive coaches, Mick and Shine and all the guys, they're dialing something here. They want to stop. There's Peterton, the lefty. He pulls it, but they did a real nice job of shadowing, and that's going to be picked off.
That's what he didn't want to do.
They did not need to do that.
He forced it. Yep. And you know what? Throw it away. Football. And like I said, he knew he didn't have anything, but he was going to try to make something happen.
Wow, that's a nice job.
That's an interception. One foot in bounds.
Is that Koretke?
Yep.
Looks like it could have been number 6, Alice Koretke. Again, we apologize.
Nice.
Those numbers are tough to read.
And he threw it into double coverage. Dave. Yeah. Don't throw that football.
That's really uncharacteristic for Cole Peterton. He's a veteran there back in that quarterback position. Go for the jugular right here. They go inside. There it is. There's that little slant in route. And that's going to be a touchdown. That's Benani, Dante Benani, their leading receiver.
And that was a great move by Benani. You watch this. I thought Dominic had him. He made a move with Dominic to get to the end zone.
Well, I tell you what, they're getting a lot of use out of this quick slant in.
Yeah, oh yeah, they're seeing something. Either they're sending the backers, which is opening up that hook curl zone behind them.
Well, Taylor Smith on to try to kick the point after touchdown, as it's now 6-3 in favor of the Rams. The snap is down, the kick is up, and it is good. As the home team jumps out by four now on our first touchdown of the ball game, with 8:09 to go to the half, it's Springford 7, PV3.
For more than 50 years, Pottstown Oral and Maxillofacial Surgery has served its community with expert dental care, offering patients dental implants and a full menu of procedures for many types of dental problems, including bone grafting, wisdom teeth, impacted canines, facial trauma, jaw surgery, oral pathology, TMJ disorders, and sleep apnea. Get the smile you've always wanted. Contact Pottstown Oral and Maxillofacial Surgery today.
The old adage is it's okay to get turnovers, but then you got to cash in and convert them. And Springford does that immediately to Benanti.
And you know what? You can have a turnover, but make something out of it. And when you do, that puts that other team, you just took their spirit away.
I remember when I coached basketball with Kenny Davis back in the day with Howard Brown and Aaron Beasley and all those good players. We want turnovers, but then we got to capitalize
right.
at the other
make
end.
It count.
Make it
count.
At the other end. And this is a real nice play, as Chad Brubaker goes for the jugular there, as they quickly turn that turnover into 7 points. And that ball's going to squiggle.
Oh.
That's going to bounce bed. They got to pick it up. That's Moshe. And again, Springford all of a sudden got the mojo. They got momentum now.
That turnover has now given them the momentum. Again, I think Peterlin's going to want to take that throw back. He knows that throw should have never been made.
Well, I'll tell you what, I think number 24, James Albert, has really helped to turn this momentum around. That real big open field tackle
with
Moshe on the screen, and then another big play where he forced Peterlin into an incomplete pass. I tell you what, he has really played well and caught my eye here early in this game.
He
Scott.
Has done a good game. You're right about that, Dave. Exactly right. And all you need is one player like that to turn something around for you.
He's a 6'1", 215-pound junior outside linebacker rush guy. He's playing very, very well. Staying in the spread, Peterlin. He wants to try to go for a deep one over there to Domini. And they want to use Domini's size because he is such a big dude.
And they're calling pass interference there. I think there's a flag thrown over there.
Wow.
And Cole, I'm not sure if this didn't come out of his hand wrong. It looked like this thing wobbled from the beginning when he threw it.
Well, he did bump him. Yeah. I don't know if he's got to have a right to touch the football.
Now, was it uncatchable?
Pushed him.
Uncatchable, that's what they're saying.
The defense, 15 yards, first down.
15 yards.
Well, Domini is 6'1 and 200 plus. He's a heck of an athlete.
And he could still go up and get that ball. I'm telling you, he could.
But again, that was sort of an unnecessary bump by that defensive back. And again, right in front of the PV coaches. Those coaches work the officials, there's no doubt about it.
You're kidding me, Dave. You think those over here working
officials? Well, Chad got that one early on the game when he thought that was a catch and a fumble or an incompletion. Here's Sturm. Sturm doing a good job.
I tell you what, he runs tough. I think that's one of the most physical runners in the league right now is Sturm. And all this was fake it and then go. Peterlin took the hit for that afterwards, and Sturm, nice job. Dip and get in, get outside. He likes to make people pay it when he tackles.
Nick Yuba, the corner, comes up and makes a tackle, but Sturm with a big game on first down, setting up a 2nd and 3. Springford looks like they want to again put some pressure on Peterlin as Albert now backs out of there. We'll see if he comes back again. There he comes. They're going to do a little pump and go. They got Rowley out there. And Rowley's able to catch it, and a beautiful thrown ball.
Yeah.
What a nice touch by Peterlin.
He threw that right over the defender's shoulder. I mean, Rowley had to turn around a little bit, but the ball was there. Great ball.
It'll be first and 10 from
the 26. No one back there behind Rowley, too. If he catches that running, he might still be running.
I'll tell you what, we're seeing two real nice high school quarterbacks right now in this ball game.
This is what high school football is about.
Hey, this whole atmosphere, the hair on my neck is still standing up, Scott.
Yeah.
And we're deep into the second quarter. There's that quick pitch again out to Sturm. This time they smell it out. That's a good play by the defense. That's Steve Brill, who doubles as that outside linebacker defensive back player.
Nice job. He did a nice job of coming up there and taking Sturm on. That was a great open field tackle with him.
He plays a little bit bigger than that 165 pounds.
Yeah, he did. He really does. He sure did.
He played that one well.
Let's go. Get in there, big man.
Second and 10. Again, Peterman in the gun. Double wides on both sides as they look over to the coach for their play. Here's Peterman drop back again. Oh, wide open. Oh,
all he had to do was lead him
there. Man. Yep. Wow. I don't know. He only went up with one hand.
One hand.
Oh, man, he was open.
And I'm not so sure that ball, a little bit behind him. He puts it out in front of me. He's cruising to the end zone.
But that referee was right in our way. What's he doing?
Cole, again, that's a throw he would like to have that back.
Yeah, I'll say that was not a typical throw for number three. Well, we got a really crucial third and 10 situation now. PV trying to answer the bell.
Watch the screen.
Under 10 seconds on the play clock. They have to be careful. Nope, there's Peterman. Oh, what a nice play inside as he got caught up in all the rush.
Tripped up by Nathaniel Orchard Robinson.
Nice job. And you know what? That's a great job to trip him up to just get his foot and take him down.
That was Orchard Robinson in on the play. That's a couple of times we've called his name. Is now Domini's going to have to drop back to punt it. Good defensive stand there at midfield by the Rams. 5:34 and counting here in the first half. 7-3 in favor of the home squad. That ball bounces. Where is it going to go? Inside the 20. Good coverage by the white shirts. And Springford is going to start at their own 17-yard line, 16-yard line.
At Superior Credit Union, we believe in growing stronger together. So we provide products and services to fit your financial needs and accommodate your busy lifestyle. With convenient services like home banking, e-deposits, account alerts, and a free coin counter for members, come see why Superior Credit Union is growing. Visit any one of our three locations in Collegeville, Royers Ford, and our brand new location in Pottstown. Superior Credit Union.
There's Engriff barking out some instructions here. PV in their 3-5-3 look. Little cat and mouse game. There to go back to the run inside as Brill gets through that first initial play.
I'm not sure how he made it through.
Almost 10. I don't either. Man, he squirted right through there.
That was a great run by Brill. And again, I thought defensively that they had it well, but good job of staying on his the lineman's back and just waiting for that breaking open.
That was a big block by James Begg, number 54, the senior tackle. Well, they're not going to measure. I thought they were going to measure. They're going to call it second and about a – oh, no. Okay, they're going to measure. Hey, while we have a quick break in the action, I want to thank all the people down here at Springford. They have made our job so nice down here. Starting with Mickey on the way down. We talked about Pat Nugent, all those guys. I tell you what, they have extended to us up here in the booth. Looks like they're going to be short. Yep, they're going to call second. Yep. Second down.
Hey, you know what? Here, Coach Babe Brubaker. Hey, put one deep. We got a third and short. You come back. Throw one down the field.
Well, this is the throwaway down that they normally call.
I'd take that shot.
They try to get the chains all lined up. See if they go with the throwaway. Who would be their long guy? Would they go to Noah Baker?
I think they're coming to a single receiver back on the back side here. I think they're going to go trips one way and throw it back on the other side.
Second down and inches for the Rams.
5 minutes even. 5 minutes to go as the clock starts on the referee's whistle. They got trips out to the right side. Here we go. Yep. Oh, okay. And there's Rowley out there. He does a heck of a job. He's one of the leading interceptors in the league with five. But it looks like there's going to be a hold on the Rams.
And again, he got flushed out of the pocket there, but he was looking to go deep. He was looking to come back to that slant again.
Boy, that really hurts on the second and inches. Now you're going to have to go back. That's a spot foul, so they're going to go back from
holding
the spot of the
on
hold.
On the offense, 10 yards from the spot of the foul, second down.
With a long yardage situation. They are behind the yard markers now, so they got a ways to go. They got second and 13 deep inside their own territory. You know, last year, one of the bugaboos for Springford in this game was they had 12 penalties in this ball game, and that did not help them when PV beat them 28-7.
But, Dave, you've commented earlier, it's been a good, clean game so far tonight.
That's a keeper on the outside there by Angro. And a good tackle. Looks like Bodine coming up, your guy.
And all it is look at this quarterback great fake that way. Getting outside here. Way to come up. Austin Rowley coming up.
I remember that name from a couple years ago.
Yeah, his brother. Yeah. Wrestling.
Yeah, good player. Wrestling. Yeah. All right, here we go. 3rd and 9. Big play. As he was knocked out of bounds and the clock stopped with 4:38 to go. Uh-oh, he's got him deep. But he pulls up. He's going to have enough for the first down. He avoids a tackle. And here comes a penalty there. It looks like there's going to be a block in the back.
Yeah, Dave.
That thing came from man.
We saw that from up here. Yeah. I don't know if it was needed. I mean, Angra gets outside here. I think he might have stepped out.
Yeah, it's a block by Noah Baker, number 35. Wanted to help his quarterback out. Yeah, that's one that
take it back.
Couldn't miss
block out. Block in the back. Offense.
That's a block in the back.
And Dave, we were talking about penalties. Here we go.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. And it's a shame because up until this point, it really had been a pretty cleanly played game.
That's been a great game, yeah.
Yeah. But I said Springford really was hurt by penalties last year as they had 12 of them in this game against PV.
And I don't know what the officials are talking about something here. I'm not sure about that.
Block in the back on the offense. 10 yards from the spot of the foul. 3rd down.
That'll be 3rd down, and they'll still have another shot for a first down.
First down.
Engro showed some more of his athleticism by breaking some tackles here, didn't he?
He's scary, Dave. I think he's scary. I think he's scarier running that football than throwing it right now.
And he's only a junior, so that does not bode well for the rest of the Pioneer Athletic Conference for the end of this year and next.
But, Dave, like you said, 21 touchdowns, 3 interceptions. That's, like you said, that's a quarterback that's making good decisions with the football.
Empty backfield. Quick throw out into the flat. He's got room to go. Brill makes one guy miss, and he's going to pick up that big, big first down. And you know, we talked about it before, every good running back breaks that first tackle.
Right, and that's an open field tackle has to be made. Rowley has him right there. Great job by Brill. That's a great job of getting the first down.
Absolutely. Good individual effort by the senior, Steve Brill. Well, that keeps the clock moving and the chains moving as well as Springford picks up another first down. Just over 4 minutes to go, so they must keep their eye on that as well as PV is really stacking the line of scrimmage here, Scott.
Yeah, and you know what? I think that's why they're seeing this slant.
What a play. What a play.
And what a ball thrown.
Man,
he put that
what.
On the spot.
And that's good coverage. He was well covered.
But the ball was put where it needed to be. It was right on the sidelines. And look at that. Hey, if his receiver did not catch it, no one was going to get that football.
Well, Engro shows more of his skills there as Benani did a nice job in one-on-one coverage. But I tell you, you can't cover him much better. Bedoin was right out there with him.
And now they're going to double Benani on this side. Here we say quads on one side.
There's a quick throw out to the outside. That looks like Scarcelli. Scarcelli showed the ability to break some tackles, but Austin Rowley comes up and really lays the wood. Austin Rowley, he's another guy that plays a heck of a lot bigger than his size. They have him listed at 5'11 and 150. He was on my show last week as the player of the week, and I stood beside him and said, I can't believe it, but this guy can really play.
But he brings it. Austin will come after. Austin will bring the wood. He brings the wood. He loves to be physical.
Well, like I said, you know, you open him up and look at the size of the heart.
That's right, Dave.
I'm fighting the dog.
I see Dave as a wrestler. He knows what it's like to be out on that mat in that single spot by yourself.
He got out of bounds, though, so the clock stops with 3:48 to go. Quads second down in about nine.
Quads again to this side. Oh!
And that's going to be an incomplete pass. What a nice play that time. That's Malik Smith as he read that baby.
That was a hit. That was an open field tackle and an open field hit.
That was a Spalding guy job there. That was a picture form tackle. Here's the play. He read it very, very well.
Malik Smith came up and a great form tackle. That is a great form tackle. Yep. People are saying fumble. He didn't have it long enough. He couldn't make a football move.
Well, Brill will take a quick breather, but I'm sure he'll be back out in the game in a second. He's a tough kid. We've seen him on both sides of the ball, and he is a physical guy himself. But what a nice play by Malik Smith the second. Third and nine now for the Rams. There's that slant again.
And what
there's
I'm
that
seeing,
slant route.
PV's blitzing the linebackers. They're leaving that slant area right open behind the linebacker.
Well, every time they stunt in the middle, they pick up that little slant route.
They pick it up, and he got the slant
route. Yep, and Austin Rowley saved the day there as he comes up with a nice stop, but not before Bonanni can pick up a first down. Yeah, I don't know if they have that automatically called or not, but it seems like whenever PV stunts in the middle, they go right to that slant, and that's wide open in the middle.
I was impressed with Springford how they picked up that blitz also, Dave. They had a nice blitz pickup.
Well, these are two well-coached teams. There's no doubt about it. Rob Heist and Chad Brubaker are very good coaches.
And Springford, nice job here with the run. They're back to the weak side. They're going to keep it moving. They're trying to be, I'd say, NASCAR offense. Keep the speed. Pick it up. Go.
That's Yoon, number 17. He's been chipping in. He's a young sophomore. Uh-oh. He pulls it. He pulls it. He pulls it. And throw! Wow, there's that run pass option at its perfection there.
That was a great read on his part. Angro made an awesome read. And he pulled this. He saw him all collapse on that running back. Great move here. Rowley has a chance at him. Can't bring him down. Angro, nice job. Nice job of running.
Well, PV's really playing a gambling-type defense right now. They're trying to fill some gaps. They're trying to make some big plays. And all you need is a little crease, and boom. Angro showed that ability to score right there. And the point after touchdown is good as Spring Ford scores his second touchdown of the second quarter.
Yeah, and again, I love it. Look at it. They tackled that back. Angro saw that. He let them go with that. Nobody really backed it. When you're spreading that offense, you're spreading out a man offense, a man-to-man defense.
Boy, I'll tell you what, we're seeing Ryan Angro grow right in front of our eyes, I tell you.
And David, you
watch this block on the side here. Real nice block on the edge.
Watch this. His eyes, look where his eyes are. Yep. His eyes are already looking at that end, and what's he doing? And you see they took
that's
him
the
there.
Block right
good
there on
kick
the edge.
Out, kick out block. Yeah. Yep.
What a nice play. Very,
well
very well
set up.
Done.
Well set up play.
Well executed, I'll tell you. Well, I'll tell you what, a little breathing room now for Spring Ford as they increase their lead to 14-3 with 2:48 to go.
And Dave,
here
I think that's
going to
make them more aggressive on defense. I think they're going to get more now aggressive on defense.
Well, we talked about Engro's ability to throw the balls. He's thrown for over 1,700 yards and 22 touchdowns coming into the ballgame. Now 23. But, boy, his ability to run really makes him a dual threat.
That's made a difference in this game right here, Dave. I think his ability to run and throw the football. They have right now, Perk Valley's not off balance. They don't know defensively what they want to do with them.
Oh, there's a good run on the catch there. That looks like Washington. He's got some room up the left side. And a nice play by number
nice
one,
return.
Joe
to
Morgan, to push him out of bounds. But what a nice play by Washington.
Yep, that was a, and you know what? He ran all the way back across the field, Dave. But Washington has that ability. His vision to see that. Lucky, good job by staying back and just stopping him.
Joe Morgan saved the day right there.
He did save the day.
He played his lane.
Yep,
just he's the safety
him.
Guy. That's what you have to do.
Slow him down.
Well, this gives him some pretty good field position.
Yeah.
It's still
they
got to
take advantage, Dave.
Yeah. I would think this is a real big series for PV. Well, they're going to go back to the ground and give it to Moshe. Moshe breaks it off the left side, runs over defender, and picks up a first down. What a collision there at the 10-yard marker there. As it looks like PV picks up a first down.
It's going to be close as it is. They are Vikings first down.
It looks like the backup quarterback, Ethan Kohler, number 8, is in the ball game as well. I don't know if Peterton got nicked or not, but they're going with the freshman. There's Jacob Sturm as he tries to pick up some yards over that left side.
And Dave, you're asking a lot of a freshman.
Yeah, I'll say.
On this stage.
Hey, I know they really like this young guy. They think he has a bright future down at PV, but you're in this championship game in this sort of atmosphere over here at Spring Ford. He's got to be shaking a little bit. Hey, we'll see what he does.
That's right.
Hope for the best for the young guy as he fumbles that one. Oh, what a nice play. What a nice play. As an incomplete pass.
But again, it started with the snap. The ball's on the ground. That throws everything off. Dave, you and I were talking how important center was before this game. You got to have a good center.
Yes, you do.
That does not help.
Every time the play is looks like it's discombobulated, it starts with a bad snap.
It's timing, Dave. Everything's done. Everything's off.
Well, we'll see what happens here at 3rd and 9. Again, let's keep our eye on number 8, young Ethan Kohler. They're going to drop him back. He's got somebody open down the sidelines. Oh, good double coverage there as the safety came over nice to help out.
And you know what? He had time here. He saw his receiver. One thing, Dave, he can't steer his receiver down. That gave that safety time to get over there and take that receiver.
You know, you're in sort of no man's
land
right here. You know, you got 4th and 10. You want to go for it and not make it. Give Spring Ford the ball back with about 1.5 to go. Or are you going to try to punt it in there and see what they can do? I don't know. It's going to be interesting.
I think Coach Trace is going to let the time go down, take a timeout, talk about it.
Yeah, I think that's a good move by Coach Heist as he wants to take a timeout.
Are you scared and don't know what to do? Are you wondering if anyone will believe you if you report abuse? Call Laurel House. Laurel House is free, confidential, and available 24 hours a day to offer emergency shelter, crisis response, counseling, and more. If you're scared, don't wait. Domestic violence is real, and this phone call could save your life. 1-800-642-3150.
Pottsgrove and the winner of this ball game will be playing for the Pioneer Athletic Conference Championship. Perk Valley has won it 2 years in a row. Pottsgrove would like nothing better than to get another shot at PV. And then we're Spring Ford, either one, and try to get a shot.
Hey, you're
Bill
in the
Hawthorne
championship
doing
game.
A game. Yeah. First year coach Bill Hawthorne doing a job, but right now, Chad Brubaker got his guys fired up for this one. Well, we'll see what's going to happen with the young freshman in there. 4th and 9. They fake inside to Sturm. He's back there. He loses the ball. And Spring Ford picks it up. They will get the ball either way because it was fourth down. They'll get the ball near midfield with a minute 26 to go.
And that's a great play. Backside pressure. He never saw the backside pressure coming. Man, the ball came out. Ball came out. Yep.
That's our buddy, Ork Fritz Robinson, again,
I'm picking on Sturm here. That's a poor block on his part. Sturm's got to get a better block there.
Well, we'll see if that gamble pays off or not for PV. I probably would have punted it there, and even though you're only going to gain a couple yards, I still want him to make him go the whole way.
Pooch the ball.
Yeah, because Engro's on fire right now. Oh, he's going to keep it around that outside. What a nice play out there on the outside. That's Kukin again.
Kukin
does a nice job.
Kukin has done an incredible game. And look, he's basically being held.
Yeah.
He just put his hand up. He took him down that way.
Yeah. As the clock continues to move now, as we approach a minute to go here in the second quarter till the half, Spring Ford is up by 11, 14-3. Long count. I'm surprised they're going long count, but they're going to run up the middle. I think Coach Brubaker likes the spot. He's being conservative here.
That's right. 14-3.
Unless they're going to try to lull you to sleep, Scott.
And you've got a freshman quarterback on the other side. I think you'd feel good going in.
Well, the clock continues to move here. Under 35 seconds to go. I don't know. Chad may not run another play. He might just take it in at halftime here and say, hey, look, we're up.
Yep,
there's those shot clocks. I really like that.
I do too, Dave.
Nice,
I think
man.
That should be on every stadium.
Yeah, I agree.
I know it's expensive, but what a nice luxury to have.
As the clock continues to go down, they're going to take a timeout just before the shot clock gets there.
9 seconds left.
So they got 9.9 to go, and Chad's going to dial something up. He's either going to run it into the line, or he's going to try to throw.
Or they're
going to
run to the locker room. One of those.
Well, don't forget, again, more action here on the PCTV Network. We'll be at Coach Pennypacker Field. What are your thoughts about that one? The winner of this game versus Pottsgrove should be interesting, Scott.
Very interesting. And I'm so happy for Bill Hawthorne, the job he's done at Pottsgrove. But you know, again, I'm looking at an explosive Spring Ford team. It's going to be tough for Pottsgrove. They're going to have an upfield battle, but yet you know Bill Hawthorne had them ready to play.
And I want to get another look at my buddy Bedolis on the outside. Ryan Bedolis has had a heck of a year for the Falcons. And you know,
I'd take him again as defensive player.
Absolutely.
I think he's had one heck of a year.
And Springfield, they got some speed, but they're going to take the victory formation. And I think this is smart. Don't give PV a chance to pick up something cheap and get them back into the ball game. And they're going to head into the locker room up by 11 at 14-3. And I think that was a good move by Chad Brubaker. All right, well, we're going to be back after the halftime festivities. But as we go into the half, it's the home team up by 11.
Limerick Bowl is the area's ultimate family entertainment center, your league bowling headquarters for all ages and all abilities. Come in anytime and enjoy daily specials or experience our weekend glow bowling. Celebrate your next birthday at Limerick Bowl with the area's most affordable party packages, now including our newly renovated family fun arcade. Limerick Bowl on West Ridge Pike. Get more information about upcoming leagues, tournaments, and open bowling specials online at limerickbowl.com.
An orthopedic institute is more than a name. It's a unique care model based on quality and compassion. Decades devoted to research and clinical trials, the development of new surgical techniques, and physicians who outperform the field. What you get from our institute is more options and more answers. For your orthopedic care, think Rothman first.
New office and 7-day urgent care now open in Limerick.
One day these rats were playing in the woods.
Wanted some matches and that's no good.
Meow. Don't play with matches, don't play with fire.
Fire.
Sort of gorgeous force is what you desire. Don't play with matches,
don't play with fire.
Only you can prevent forest fires.
Fire.
And you get a good look at the Bill Berge as they give away a truck here at halftime as part of the promotions here at Coach McNally Stadium at Springfort Area Senior High School. Dave Ridenour, Scott Furman bringing you all the action here. 14-7 as Springfort kicks off to Upper Perk. Upper Perk catches it inside their 10-yard line, and Moshe gets brought down below the 20 with a couple of penalty markers to boot.
And what were they?
I don't know. I don't know, but two of them flew in there. I don't know.
They came in, Dave. I'm not sure what I saw. I didn't see really anything.
I don't know if they hit him too hard.
Or PV's going to be starting deep.
Because I didn't see anybody even around to throw a block in the back or a clip or anything.
On the return team, right? Block in the back.
Well, it's going to go against.
It's going to start deep in the room end zone, too.
With the freshman in there, it's not going to be good. And this is going to be a tough second half for the Vikings.
Especially digging a hole like this. Yes. You're, like you said, starting your field position.
Return team, half the distance from the spot of the foul.
Well, we got an official word there, too.
Yeah.
Some sad news for the PV gang. Cole Peterton, I don't think, will be able to suit it up and play the second half, so they're going to have to go for Ethan Kohler, the young freshman quarterback, and Ted, who has a bright, bright future, but I don't know if he's ready yet.
Well, he's gotten thrown to the fire tonight.
There's a nice ball right outside to John Moshe. Hey, maybe they rally around this young guy. Seriously. You never know. We've seen crazier things happen, Scott.
And Dave, you know what? I've had the opportunity to coach. I'm impressed with his composure and the way he plays the game. He's just got to stay within the system. That's all he has to do. Don't do anything special. Just stay within what Coach Ice wants you to do.
Well, I think this is where your offensive line really has to pull together and say, listen, we got to help this young guy out. Yeah, we can't do it all. He can't do it all. We got to help him.
Or your run game has to go well.
There's that pitch to the outside. Jake Sturm, but a nice play inside. I think that's Noah Baker, who's really played a good game on both sides of the ball.
They, and you know what? Perk Valley had success with that the first play. But after this, Springford's done a great job of defending it. Yeah, all over the ball.
Remember, we are in Springford for the rights to play Pottsgrove next week for the Pioneer Athletic Conference Championship. The winner of this game will be the Liberty Division champions, which is the larger schools in the Pioneer Athletic Conference. Perk Valley has won it the last 2 years, and Springfort would like nothing better than to upseat them here on their senior night.
And, you know, I think for Coach Heiss, be conservative a little bit offensively, throwing the football with the freshman. Let him work into this game.
Well, at 3rd and 3, though, they want to try to move the sticks, Scott, so they got some things that they have to do also to try to keep Springfort offense on the sideline because they really turned it up another notch in that second quarter. Shot clock. Wow. And that things could not be going worse for PV than right there.
Right there.
Nick Del Romano with the recovery.
And that was just a bad snap. I mean, come on, you got the quarterback who's standing at 6 feet, and that thing was over his head.
Yeah.
That's what you can't have happen.
Boy, I tell you, Coach Heiss, this has got to be his worst nightmare to come out. They were moving the ball fairly well. They had a 3rd and short.
And here it is. I mean, that thing went right up over his head.
We'll see what Coach Brubaker does now as the Springfort stands are all on their feet. The kids are having a great time down there in the student section. Empty backfield. They fake inside. Look at Engro. Look at Engro going for the pylon.
Did you see
he took that ball around his back? Yeah. He must be a hooper too. Must be a hooper.
Yeah. Wow. That was pretty neat.
That was pretty neat.
And here's, watch the quarterback. Ball goes around his back. Again, good job by Perk Valley hunting it down. They'll get Zamlonico getting to the football.
Lomanaco bumped him out of bounds. Again, though, Springfort is 2nd and goal from the 2. They have trips out here to our side, and they're going to try to run back up into the middle. Good thrust by, but what a second effort. What a second effort. Is that Andrew Yoon, number 17?
And wow. That's just a great effort. He eluded the tackles. He wanted the end zone. And again, he should have been tackled twice.
Just a young sophomore listed at 5'9 and 160, but he looked like Jim Brown on that play. Brown, I'll tell you what, he just wanted it more.
One.
They've had a great job of penetration right there. They had him stopped in the backfield.
And they had him stopped there. He wanted it more.
Wow.
He wanted the end zone.
Uh-oh.
Wow, we're seeing some snaps
tonight.
Must
be contagious. This bad snap thing's contagious, Scott. Is that that ball was well over the holder's head.
Ball this way.
20-3 is the score now, as you get a good look at Dante Ciacci, who one of the offensive linemen who paved the way for Yoon. There you see Chad Brubaker. He's got to be very happy on the sideline.
I mean, what a way to start. You didn't really do anything defensively much. I mean, Kirk Fire hurt himself in that snap. They just dug this whole deep with this freshman to bring this team back. There's no doubt about it.
I don't know how many times you and I have talked about it, how important the center is when you're in that spread formation. You know, he is so, so essential. Besides the quarterback, he's number two on the field. I mean, if his snaps are not good, the play cannot get started and the timing is off. And boy, that could have been worse for PV.
Yeah. But Dave, we were saying, start him at junior high. You got to find him then. Start him then, work your way up if you're going to be in the shotgun.
The thing is, they're going to need a defensive score or a special team score or something crazy like that to try to get themselves back in the game now, yeah. Scott.
Yep, something has to happen here.
Taylor Smith is the kicker for Spring Ford. He's a senior. Man, good leg there. Is that Moshe backside again? Well, he has nowhere to go. Again, Springford is fired up.
Yeah, as I say, and they're beating him to the ball right now.
There's blood in the water right now as the Rams are really, really going after it. Springford has to be really happy with the way things are right now as things are going their way.
Kirk Valley, now you got to get your, like you said, Dave, they've got to throw now to get back into this game a little bit here. They got to score this possession. And he just threw this up. We're talking. You know, he scrambles out of the pocket, but don't force the throw. Somebody's underneath him.
Andrew Yoon, I'll tell you what, he just came up with that big touchdown run there. He makes the INT on the defensive side of the ball. Yep. Another ill-advised pass by young Kohler.
Throw the ball away.
This thing could get ugly in a hurry here. If PV's not able to work some sort of offense and keep the ball out of Spring Ford's hands, because, as I said, they're smelling blood in the water now, Scott.
Yep.
Here's Engro. He's going to pass. There's that little slant route again.
He threw that into quite a few Vikings there, Dave. Kirk Valley defended that one well. And they were ready for that one there. They saw that slant coming. That was knocked out the line of scrimmage.
Good D that time by a PV as they create a second and 10 now for Spring Ford. Single setback. There's Engro again. Nice play defensively.
Good job by PV. They're putting the pressure on them now. Again, being aggressive. Try to be aggressive.
Hunter Ricci did a nice job there from his outside linebacker position as they're trying to keep some pressure on Ryan Engro. A little surprised they didn't go to the run there a little bit more. Chew some clock. He's going for the home run right away.
Yeah, put the pressure back on PV. They've got to be the ones to score right now.
Okay, a little confusion here on the offensive side of the ball.
I'm just missing a few zeros there.
They got Benani over there singled up. We'll see if they go that way. Yep, they're going to run a little post corner to Benani. Oh, it hits him in the hands, too.
He should have caught
that. He had his hands on it.
And again, he had a quick there to get into the coverage here. Great place ball. Come on. Angrim can't throw a better ball than that one right there.
Well, he was one-on-one with probably one of the better corners in the league with Isaiah Domini, and he beat him to the corner.
That was a great placement of the ball for Angrim.
Well, they're going to go for it here on fourth down. Fourth and about 14, maybe 15. Angrim in the backfield all by himself, empty set. They're going to run that little fade route to Noah Baker.
Nice
and that
job.
One hits his hands. God. Two passes
Isaiah
in a row that could have been caught.
Yep. Isaiah Gendo, good job of being there. He was on him.
Well defended.
I'm impressed with Ingram throwing this ball. And this ball, again, is... I thought Isaiah got his fingertips on that.
Close. Real close.
Good job. Hey, but PV, now let's go. Make something happen. Here you go. You've gotten some momentum. Now you've got to take advantage.
Well, they got to get some first downs. You know what I mean? They got to hold the ball for a little while.
Get
something going consistently. You know, Coach Heiss has got to try to figure out something that works for him on offense.
Thank you to everyone for their support of tonight's 50-50.
They go back to the run game there. That's Moshe. Some tough sledding inside, though. I tell you.
I'm daring you to run the football right now for Springford. Go ahead. Run it all you want.
Orkvik Robinson again, and we've called his name a few times here tonight with some tackles. There he does a good job after a gain of two on John Moshe. This is where Springford's had some success. Oh, man, that's a backward pass, isn't it?
Nope. Yeah, that was backwards.
Yeah.
There's no doubt of that. I want to see where they spot the ball. They're calling it incomplete, Dave.
They're going to call that incomplete, although I thought that was,
it was
a backwards pass. PV got lucky there. That was certainly backwards, and that ball could have been spotted right there and would have been a third and really, really long. Now they still have to deal with third and eight.
And here we go. The quarterback's on the 29. Oh, yeah, there's no doubt.
Oh, yeah, that's at least 2 yards backwards. Yeah. Yep. Nice screen pass inside to Austin Rowley. Austin Rowley looking for room to run. Real nice call by the coaching staff as Nick Yuba saved maybe a touchdown.
Yeah, and you know what? Set up very nicely. Kohler did a great job of keeping his composure there and dumping it off to Austin Rowley. And then Austin made it happen after that.
Well, you talked about it earlier. Coach Heiss loves the screen game. He does like that
screen
game. And there they threw a nice one inside to Austin Rowley. Rowley is the second leading receiver on the squad. He came in with 20 catches for the year. There they're trying to go deep again to Domini.
Yeah.
Oh, that goes through his hand.
You know, and I thought the quarterback got hit right here at the end. He couldn't even see his arm. He couldn't release the ball far enough.
Oh, man, I tell you what, that was close.
Yeah.
Domini still could come up with that play. As good as he is,
he can make this play. Just to see releasing. He can't follow through. His arm got stuck in here, and that ball got stuck up there.
Yeah, that hit him. Hit him in the breadbasket. Second and 10 for PV. Domini came into tonight's game with 30 catches in the league, and a league high 10 touchdowns. One out of three catches goes for a score. There's a nice pass inside again, but they got to help your guys out. You know, you got to help your buddy
help
out there.
They're going to help the freshman. You're not helping your quarterback right now. You're right.
Third down for Valley.
I hit Mike Dockery between the one and the five and said, you know, you got to help your young freshman out.
And Dave, I thought I saw two receivers in the same area there also for PV.
We'll see what they come up with here now on third and 10. PV's line's got to give him some time here now as they're going to roll him. Oh, he's going to keep it, but he's caught down from behind.
No time from the backside. Nope. The backside drug him down. And this is just a great hustle play. A great hustle play.
There right now, Springfield is really playing aggressive. They look fast.
Dave, you said they're playing fast. Their ears back and they're coming.
They're playing fast, and PV's going to have to punt. They have to punt from here.
You don't want to give field position. No
right.
way.
You can't be giving up short fields.
DJ Francis here with that play that chased the quarterback down, took him down.
6:47 to go here in the third quarter. PV is forced to punt. Isaiah Domini back to kick it. They have been pretty, but they got some success out of them. Here's a floater and a fair catch caught. Domini does a nice job of sliding in there and catching that ball on the 20-yard line, where Springford will take over first and 10.
At Superior Credit Union, we believe in growing stronger together. So we provide products and services to fit your financial needs and accommodate your busy lifestyle. With convenient services like home banking, e-deposits, account alerts, and a free coin counter for members, come see why Superior Credit Union is growing. Visit any one of our three locations in Collegeville, Royers Ford, and our brand new location in Pottstown. Superior Credit Union.
Back to the spread. Give off inside to Brill. Brill was hurt a little bit earlier, but looks like he's recovered and picks up a big first down as they will move the chains again.
I tell you what, Brill does a nice job. And all this is just this little sweep out to the right here. And again, he reads his block, he cuts up inside. He's tough to bring down, he runs tough.
Well, it looks like Springford's offensive line is starting to wear him out a little bit, too.
You're right, Dave. We saw earlier, I think PV was taking it offensively, but now you're right. Springford's moving the offensive line.
Well, both these two teams came in undefeated in the Liberty Division. The winner will play Pottsgrove, as we mentioned. We will be doing that game on the PCTV Network next Friday night at Coach Pennypacker Field in Pottsgrove. But right now, Springford has the upper hand, and they appear to be ready to go.
There's the offensive line. I mean, those are the guys up front, Spags, Terrizzi, you know, Brogan. They're doing a great job. They are opening holes at giving Angro time right now.
And they have really grown into be a pretty good group. Yeah, I know Coach Brubaker was a little concerned about his offensive front. They lost some guys from last year, but they are really doing a heck of a job. And how about some congratulations and kudos to the offensive line coach for molding these guys together. There's Brill again on around that right side as he picks up another first down as they continue to move the chains again.
And Dave, what they're doing is putting the formation to the wide side and running back into the short side, and they're keeping Perk Valley off balance defensively.
Yeah, PV's got to dig down deep right now. Springford going tempo as well. No huddle, spread formation, three receivers to the near side, single setback. They're going to go back to him. They're going to ride him now. He's their senior. He's the workhorse.
And that clock just keeps running. That's all you want. Keep the clock running. That pressure goes back on Perk Valley.
For the Rams, it'll be second and 8:32 left.
I said Brill came off his best game of the season last week, where he rushed for 125 yards. And the Rams' big win. So they're going to keep on riding them.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Heck, yeah. And watch it now, because Angro's putting you to sleep with that Brill, 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 and then Angro's going to keep it one of these times.
He's shown the ability to do that in the first half, and he's quicker than you think. Oh, there's a bad pass there. One of the few bad passes Ryan Angro has thrown tonight. Coach Brubaker, not happy. I'm sure he'll let Angro know. Very demanding coach on his quarterback.
Yeah. And if you want to play for him, that's what you're going to take.
Yeah. Well, he's filling some pretty big shoes from last year. Old TJ Pergine did a heck of a job for the Rams. Third and 8. Let's see if they go back to the air or try to get it on the ground. As Steve Brill has really had some nice runs here in the second half. Some pressure right away. Look at this. Look at Engro, how he's able to elude it. And at least gets it up to the line of scrimmage where they won't lose 20 yards. Well, you know what? I think that's a tribute to the little bit tired. You know what? They're not as crisp as they were in the beginning. You know, they're a little beat down. They're looking to score. Their quarterback is sidelined. So it's a little bit tough on PV right now. And you can see. And that ball is going to roll down to the 24-yard line. And PV will start right there when we come back right after this word from our sponsor.
When did you see the sign?
When I needed to jumpstart sales.
Build attendance for an event.
Help people find their way. Fast Signs designed new directional signage.
And got them back on track. Get started at fastsigns.com.
Speed sweep to John Moshe as he tries to go over that left side, but looks like Nick Yuba was there to greet him, to push him out. Well, you know, and I think almost all night, even when Peterman was in there, they have really been searching for some consistency on the offensive side, Scott. Second and seven now for the Vikings, deep in their own territory again. Their field position has not been good. There's the young freshman as he tries to make something out of it. But good defense.
Tripped up on the play, Ryan Colander.
Colander doing a nice job there, staying with the play. Defensive end, 6'4", 200. Again, you know, besides the big guy at 6'7", 295, they're not overly big, but they're nice-sized kids.
Yep. They're aggressive. They're getting to the ball, and they're being aggressive on that front of that line.
Nice pass over the middle to Austin Rowley. Rowley lowers his shoulder. And a good play right at midfield.
Nice ball by the quarterback Kohler, too. Nice ball. Stood in the pocket. Nice ball. Had the time. Give him time.
That's Von Hulse, number 11, in on that tackle. But again, that little Austin Rowley is one of my favorite
guys. Man.
I'm telling you, he's a tough little dude.
He's a physical football
player. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Nice pitch and catch that time by Kohler and Rowley. There they go inside to Jake Sturm. Sturm tries to get to the outside, gets a first down, and a little bit more as they are now in Springford territory.
Keep it going.
As they're picking up a little bit more momentum.
Keep it going. Get that NASCAR speed offense going.
Well, I think that they don't have to go to that bombs away offense. You know, now they're going to try some trickeration here. Let's see what they got going here with this. All right, Springford quickly calls timeout. Good play by Jimmy Mick Jr. and Chad Brubaker. We're going to take a timeout. There's a timeout on the field. It's Springford 20 and PV 3.
Yakalak Construction, serving the Tri-County area since 1946. Family-owned, free estimates, all types of concrete work, sidewalks, foundations, steps, curbs, and more. Professional service and quality. Give them a call, 610-323-8134.
Well, we'll see what happens here after this timeout is... PV tried a little trickeration. What were they going to do out of that?
Well, made him call timeout. If that was one of their goals, they made him do that.
All right. If nothing else, they got Springford to lose one of their timeout. Okay. All right.
They had something set up there, Dave, and I wouldn't be surprised they come back to it.
Well, Springford may be ready for it now since they had an opportunity to sort of plan for it. First and 10 now inside Springford's end of the field. There's that little throwback play again. It's had some success earlier. But Andrew Yoon doing a nice job, number 17, out of his cornerback spot.
Yeah. He took on Rowley, and he came up and made the tackle. That was a great open field tackle.
Yeah, and John Moshe is certainly no slouch out of that backfield.
Right.
He's got good strength in the lower body. He's a quick guy. I really thought he might be one of the keys to this game for PV. If they could get him on track a little bit and get him some yards, get him the ball out in space. But, boy, Yoon did a nice job of making that tackle for no gain.
You're right. Dave, that was a great open field tackle.
That was. Another pass. They're trying to go over the middle to Domini, and that ball bounces. And that looked like Andrew Yoon back there again.
And it looked like he just didn't have enough, or he did have enough on it, though.
Couldn't quite tell from that angle whether that was underthrown or not, or Domini sort of lost sight of the ball. Anyhow, it's third and 10. We're still waiting for Isaiah to have an impact on this game. You know, he really hasn't done much offensively. Credit to Springford defense.
I was going to say, I think they've been doing a great job of doubling him and making sure somebody's underneath and over top of him.
Uh-oh. Doherty stole it.
Doherty came up with it.
I think Doherty
stole it right
out of his hand.
That comes up with it.
Holy smoke.
Yeah.
What a play by Mike Doherty.
Man, come up, prove who has the ball.
Well, triple reverse pass. Boy, that's a heck of an effort there by Doherty. As Yoon had him well covered, well played.
Greatly, he had to defend it great.
Uh-oh. Got something there, a little false start.
And here's another angle on that catch. I mean, remember, it would go offensive possession, but Doherty fought for this ball.
Yeah, he did. Yes, he did. I'll tell you, what a nice play, 15. He's only a junior, 5'11", 155, and, boy, he really went up and got that. Andrew Yoon has really done a nice job at the corner.
Well defended. That was well defended. I mean, just Doherty came up with the ball. Important for PV. They got to come away with a touchdown here, Dave. They can't come out empty-handed.
Absolutely.
Got to have a touchdown.
Field guards aren't going to do
gonna
it.
Help you know. Nope.
So they got first and 13 here. Oh. Good pressure off the corner.
Just doesn't have time to get rid of the ball.
Like Del Romano, number 8, really put some quick pressure on him from his outside linebacker spot. He got in Kohler's face, and Kohler really could not throw the ball. Tried to find one of his buddies out there in the flat area. It looked like he was open. I don't know. I might be looking for number 23 in a little crossing route here if I was DB.
Or I say single, put Isaiah single on the backside.
Well, that didn't work.
Kohler's keeper, Nathaniel Orchkins Robinson, brings him down.
Well, that play worked for Ingram a little bit earlier. And Peterman did a nice job with that quarterback draw, but
I think
Springford
had
really
that,
converged
had that
on
ready.
Him, I'll tell you,
yep,
Scott.
They had that one ready. I think you got to throw two to the end zone now.
Yeah,
you've
got
to put the ball in the end zone.
PV cannot get a first down. So they have about 16 yards to go here on third and goal. There's young Kohler doing a nice job. Picks up some good yardage. However, it's going to be stopped well short. Again, there's my buddy James Albert, who's really been a force on the defensive side of the ball. Oh, they're going to kick a field goal here. I'm surprised by this move. That gets it down to 14 if they make it, I guess.
That was a good drive, though.
It was a good drive.
Offensively, a nice drive.
But again, Springford did a real nice job in the red zone.
That's right.
They bent, but they did not break.
Bend, but don't break. That's right.
to see what Basil can do here. Boy, that's a nice kick. Nice kick, Basil. As Braden Basil with another field goal as PV doubles the score to 6. We're going to take a timeout with 41 seconds to go. 20-6. Spring Ford.
An orthopedic institute is more than a name. It's a unique care model based on quality and compassion. Decades devoted to research and clinical trials, the development of new surgical techniques, and physicians who outperform the field. What you get from our institute is more options and more answers. For your orthopedic care, think Rothman first.
New office and 7-day urgent care now open in Limerick.
Well, Scott, you know, you talked about it. It was certainly a nice drive that they put together. Unfortunately, they had to settle for 3. Really, tell you what, inside their own end, Springford has really played solid defense.
And you're right, PB was down earlier in the game. That came away at 3. And they were first to go from the 3.
There's a little low squib kick. Ball's bounding, 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 bounding. Wow. Boy, there are those ones that if you break through that first wave, you could go about 90. But give PV a lot of credit, man. They're hanging in there.
All you need is a turnover down here, Dave, and things can start getting a little.
Yeah, the return man a little slow getting up. Is that Andrew Yoon? That might be Yoon.
Andrew Yoon.
36.8 seconds to go here in the third quarter. We'll see if they run one play, and then we'll walk the field down to the other end line. As the play clock continues to move now, it's down to 17. Got the big guy in on offense now, too. It's first I've seen him play, 64, I believe. Well, there's Angro. Boy, he's dangerous in his position. But good defense by PV, led by number 29, Dave Stewart. I think Chad Brubaker's going to let the clock run out here, and they're going to move down to the other end of the field. We're going to start the fourth quarter with the score 20-6 in favor of the home squad. Well, we're going to take a quick timeout, and we come back for fourth quarter action right after this.
Hi, I'm Joe, and this is Chris, and many of you know us. And we'd like to welcome you to our new showroom here at 618 North Reading Avenue in Boyertown, where we offer Kohler faucets, Moen faucets as well, vanities, tubs, and many accessories.
Here we have an operating, high-efficiency, Energy Star-rated American Standard furnace combined with a variable-speed AC condenser. Let us install one today to start saving you money throughout the heating and cooling season.
Here at Patriot, we now offer kitchen and bath designs.
So come visit us today at 618 North Reading Avenue or visit our website at www.patriotmp.com.
We're back here at the fourth quarter. Springford, 2nd and 5. Give the ball right up the middle. Good solid play defensively for Upper Perk. Looked like Dave Stewart again, number 29. Hunter Ritchie, number 27.
Nice shot again. Hey, PV just got to hold him. Hold him, give him, make him punt, and then maybe field position can help him out. But Dave, how many touchdowns?
Yeah, this would be a perfect spot for a 3 and out if you're PV.
Yes.
You know, you might get win the battle of field position here, force him into a punt from deep in their own end. This is a big defensive call for the Vikings. Going to the air. Got him. What a nice pitch.
Nice throw, too. Yep. Bonini. And a Bonini, nice job of going down for the football. This was low. Nice catch.
Throws it where only one guy can get it.
Yeah,
Bonini.
That's right. Yep.
And that's a good matchup there. Bonini and Domini, two of the better athletes in this league. Like I said, Bonini came into this ball game as the leading receiver with 31 catches and 7 touchdowns for Springford.
Now they gotta get
some pressure on him.
Gotta get some pressure on him.
Nice play by Brett Keegan. Keegan again with another nice tackle.
And Brett, great job. He read the quarterback all the way there. He did not go for the fake.
Well, we've seen that Ryan Ingro break some of those tackles earlier. So he did a nice job of holding on, and then Hunter Ritchie came in helping him to finish him off. All right, let's see what happens now. Second and 15. Whole bunch of receivers out here. Little curl route inside. That ball's behind Scarcelli. Let's see what happens now. Looks like Engro might have taken
moving
a
his
shot
arm.
There.
Yeah, he keeps swinging his arm around.
Yeah,
yeah, you're right, Dave.
He took a shot.
That may have an effect on him.
But that ball didn't come out cleanly.
No.
That ball was low and outside. But again, Springford's going to go four wide over here. Empty set. They're going solo on the far sideline. See if they run quarterback draw here. See if they got a spy on him. Yep, get a spy on him. That's a good series of downs.
Good stop.
PV.
Yep, good stop. Stop.
Good stop. They did let up that one first down.
And I don't think, Coach Brubaker's not messing. He's going to kick this.
Yeah, he's not going to worry about the pooch kick and all that other kind of stuff.
Yep.
That's Taylor Smith who come in.
I got to tell you, I saw him kicking before the game. I was impressed. This kid could punt a ball.
Well, let's see who he puts back. They're going to put Domini back. See if he can do something. He's really been in check tonight offensively. Springford really kept their eye on number 6. There's a low liner. Stay away from it. You'll get the ball inside the 50-yard line. And good hustle that time by Koretke as they down it. PV will take over. When we come back, it'll be first and 10 at PV.
There's a place for wood in your backyard. We recommend the fire pit. For looks and performance that outlast a wooden deck, make sure your next deck is built with Trex. Engineering what's next in outdoor living.
Your Trex expert is A.D. Moyer Lumber. ADMoyer.com.
You know, Kohler, enough time to throw here. That was there.
A couple of them. I'll tell you, Domini's had an opportunity to make some catches. Yeah. And normally, you know, you're an all league caliber guy. You're a guy who's going to play at the next level. You got to make some plays here. Had a little push off there. Didn't get caught. And he still found a way not to catch it. Kohler going to keep it. He's got a lot of room out here. Does a good job of getting out of bounds and avoiding taking that shot.
Smart. Stop that. And you know what? He was looking to his right all the way here. But then he came back and nobody was at home. They were playing man. Everybody ran off, followed their man.
Well, when you get him in that man
position
where their back is turned to the quarterback, keep it and go.
Yep.
Nice play by the young freshman. I tell you what, he's going to learn a lot in this game.
That's right, Dave. He'll grow up. He'll grow up in this game, and this is going to pay off.
And especially if he has to go next week, you know, if Peterton isn't able to come back from his injury, you know, he's going to have to play in a big game. There we go.
Dominate. There we go.
Has
a catch.
When he gets himself in position.
Yep. And that's what's great. He had time to throw. Isaiah did a great job here getting inside position on the ball.
And then, you know what I liked there too even more is number 52, Kyle Rittenhouse, one of his offensive linemen, came back there and gave the youngster a little high five to the quarterback
there. He needs
some confidence
too, Davey. He needs that confidence.
Yep.
But they got. Here's where they've had trouble. Here's where Springford has tightened up and not allowed them in the end zone.
Well, I'll tell you what. Give that one to the veteran, Isaiah Domini.
That was good, He tried to go for the catch.
He pulled that one off.
And that was because of his effort to go for that catch.
Yes. Yep.
Yeah, all the way.
He made the official throw that pass, or the flag, as he went for the pass. And the defensive back was sort of standing there in good field position. And Domini
pulled
that one off.
On the defense. Half the distance from the goal. First down.
That'll give him a first down inside the 5-yard line. First and goal.
Got to come away with points here, not just three, Dave. Three's not going to do it anymore.
Springford shoots right up the gut there, and they get Moshe deep in the backfield as he's going to lose a couple yards on that one.
Big 61 for Perk Val. Took a Springford and an official out.
Well, you know, it's funny that when Springford gets in this goal line situation, they seem to be really shooting in that guard center gap, and PV has not been able to pick it up.
Pick it up. You're right there. They're filling the gaps,
Yep. Now it's second and goal from the 6 as they lost 2 on the play. They throw it out there to Moshe. And, again, that's close to being a lateral.
He wasn't open. No. Springford had that well defended.
Yeah, they did.
They had that well defended.
That's Blake Terizzi, number 52, who was out there on the play. Like, you can only go to the well a few times. Yeah, that
was just a swing pass. Yeah. That's all that was.
Wow, 3rd and 6 now to go. See what Coach Heiss can come up with here. Yep, he's going to take a timeout. He knew that things weren't going right, and he needed to take a timeout and talk to his young freshman quarterback. He realizes how important this is.
This is the year you're going to improve your game. No excuses. And the pros at Blackwood Golf Academy are here to help. With their 23-acre all-grass driving range, full-service pro shop, and computerized swing analysis, Blackwood Golf Academy will get your game up to par. Need lessons? Individual and group instruction with head pro Chris Carr will shave strokes off your game and make you the envy of your next foursome. Blackwood Golf Academy, a country club setting open to the public, adjacent to Blackwood Golf Course in Douglasville.
Well, we'll see what they dialed up here as Coach Heiss called a timeout on his 3rd and goal from the 6. Single setback. That's Sturm. Fake it off inside to him. Kohler rolls to the right side. Can he get to the pylon?
Yeah,
and he does.
Nice job. Touchdown.
The young freshman.
Nice job.
Yeah, got into the
end zone. That was nice composure, Dave, on his part.
Well, it looked like that fake held him just enough to get the edge.
And he was going to throw that. I think he was going to throw that. He was looking to throw that to his left. But again, everything taken to the right, he took off. This adds pressure to Springford now.
Yeah, big extra point right now. Making a 7-point ball game. Uh-oh. Oh, my. Oh,
20-12.
Well, I tell you what, that could be a big miss. A big, big miss. Now we got an eight-point game. Now they got to go for two if they're fortunate enough to get a touchdown here.
And Springford's got to do something offensively here. They can't give another three and out. Yeah, I saw the hold come back here. It looked like the snap was a little off for the hold. And watch, that's a holder. He has to kind of reach. Okay, it was okay. Laces.
You got to make that.
You got to make it. Yep, that's right.
I mean,
that's all that was.
But you still have to make that kick. And Basil has been pretty solid all game. He just rushed it and pulled it left a little bit.
But you're right, Davey. That was a big point.
Yeah, it was a big point. Yes, it was. Well, let's see if Springford again can answer the bell. They haven't done much offensively here as of late. They look really sharp in that second quarter where they scored two touchdowns. Still plenty of time with 8 minutes to go here in this ball game. Good long kick. Right up the middle.
Butter Valley Golf Course. Conveniently located in the quiet rural setting of Valley, PA, just off Route 100. One of the nicest, most affordable 18-hole course in the region. With changing elevations, challenging greens, and scenic fairways, golfers of all ability levels are sure to enjoy their round. Butter Valley Golf Course is a great place to enjoy the game of golf with friends or family, young and old alike. Grab some buddies and grab a meal at the Runway Grill before or after your round. Butter Valley Golf Course.
First and 10 from their own 29. Right back to the air again. There's that slant route that had been successful.
That's
Benanni. Yeah.
6 yards. Second and three.
And they're going to hurry up. That's sort of surprising. They're going up tempo, trying to catch PV off guard and tired.
The ball! He lost the ball.
A fumble.
It was a fumble, and PV recovered. Yep.
And Malik Smith with a big fumble recovery.
And all that was, they stripped him. Brill had it. And somebody, from behind.
Yeah, nice
quad
player.
Quad pushed it, hit that.
That looks like
big boy pushed it right out.
That's Quad Deer doing a nice
quad
job.
Knocked that right out.
Yeah. Quad Deer Shedrick, 6'4", 320 from behind. Watch the big guy, number 79, Scott.
Yeah, coming down the line, he punches it out from behind. Quadir did a great job punching that out.
Boy, does that extra point look big now, doesn't it? Oh, man. Holy smokes.
A lot bigger.
Yeah. There's the pitch. They got Sturm on the outside. Can he get the corner? And he does. He picks up about 8. PV coaches are not happy. They thought there was a horse collar tackle on the play. We couldn't see from over here. I can see Rob Heist pleading his case over there as they looking at might be close to a first down.
No, Sturm's down. Sturm is down. And here we go. No, this is just a little flip out option here. Yep.
That's why those plays are illegal and penalized.
Yeah, right.
Because
right.
You have a chance to
happens.
Hurt the guy.
That's
yeah.
The results of it, Dave, right there.
I mean, they used to be legal to play, and a lot of running backs, receivers, guys with the ball, you hurt your lower leg, you hurt your ankle on that play. And
that's why
you
that's
can
right.
See, I don't know if we can show that again, Gus, but it looked like he was definitely in the back of the shoulder pads.
Yep. Here it is again. I mean, you can watch it again. Sturm, I thought, had the corner, Dave. You said I thought he was going to run for the, get some running room there. And then, 36 just has the.
Yeah. You know, when you're behind and you're trying to catch up, you can do that. And it looked like he did have the hand down in the back of the shoulder pads. But, hey, they didn't call it. Second and two.
Go on.
Play on. Hopefully Sturm will be able to get back in the ball game. Back to the pass. Oh, they're going one-on-one out here to Rowley. Oh, nice D. Nice D. Good defense
good
that time.
Good inside position by the defensive
forward.
Back.
Looking for a rally.
Yeah. Kohler has to throw that more down into the corner there. Let Rowley run for it.
Ryan Yang on the defense.
Good defensive play by Springford. Third and two. Is that Stern back in the ball game? Nope.
They don't have a quarterback on the field. They're going to run to. Now they came someone from the sidelines.
They better call a timeout. This is going to be bad. Yeah.
Yeah, that was not set up right.
Right.
I saw Kohler go off the field, and I'm wondering they were going to run a wildcat.
What, did Kohler get hit at the end of that play?
I think he just ran out. I think it was a wildcat they were going to run with motion.
Well, we're going to take a timeout. We'll get it all straightened out when we come back. This is exciting. 20-12.
Limerick Bowl is the area's ultimate family entertainment center. Your league bowling headquarters for all ages and all abilities. Come in anytime and enjoy daily specials or experience our weekend glow bowling. Celebrate your next birthday at Limerick Bowl with the area's most affordable party packages. Now including our newly renovated family fun arcade. Limerick Bowl on West Ridge Pike. Get more information about upcoming leagues, tournaments, and open bowling specials online at limerickbowl.com.
Again, how crucial are we now? We're down to crunch time, under 7 minutes to go. An 8-point game, third and two. Kohler's back in the ball game. Oh, he's going deep again.
Touchdown!
And what a catch!
Touchdown!
Isaiah Domini, holy smokes! Boy, he missed a couple early, but you can see the skill set that he has, Scott.
And his concentration on that ball, he was well defended. Ball's up, the receiver has it. Isaiah just got good position. But David, like we said, that 1 point mattered. Now he's been out, forces to go for two.
Well, you know, it shows some of that basketball skill. It's almost like he's boxing out rebound out there.
And got it. And Kohler, I like this. He looked left, came back right. He knew he had Isaiah on the backside, one-on-one. That's great concentration.
Guys are right there. Their defensive backs are inches from making the play. Look at this.
Touchdown,
at this.
Ties it up.
Wow. Wow. You talk about a freshman growing up right in front
of our eyes. Right
How
there.
About Ethan Kohler as we're all tied up at 20 apiece?
And you know what? He was wide open in the end zone. I don't think anybody was on the receiver.
Nobody picked him up.
That's
they went
mojo.
Four wide receivers, and he was wide open, left alone. And I mean, what?
Yep.
Give the freshman a lot of credit for recognizing the defense. Well, I tell you what, I don't know if Springford got a little lackadaisical or what, because it looked like the game from 10 minutes ago was well in hand. Now, all of a sudden, it's tied 20 up.
And, Dave, it wasn't for that gaffe or mess up by PV early. I mean, Springford really hasn't done anything offensively for themselves. They've got to come up with something here.
We got ourselves a ball game here now, and Chad Brubaker's got to do some soul searching with his squad to try to get them fired up again as they got to reseize the momentum. Springford had the momentum the whole second period and most of the third, and now all of a sudden PV has jumped up and grabbed it. What a game. What a game. Now you can see why they're both undefeated coming into this ball game and playing for the right to play.
And why you would expect this type of game from these two teams.
Yeah. Okay, there's a little mix up there at the end. Uh-oh. What a return.
Big return from Anthony Brown.
Wantoni Brown.
And that's how you answer,
Dave. That could be the spark.
But that's how you answer.
He wanted that, too. He took it right away from the other receiver.
Yeah.
And Wantoni showed great speed to the outside.
Yep. Now let's see, man. You know, Springford has to get something going here offensively.
Yeah, and I think they have to go back to the run game a little bit. There's that run pass option outside to Scarcelli. And boy, PV's all over one. Yeah. They also got some good things going on. That's Lingo, number 13, really doing a nice job. You know, Stephen Brill had some success in that second half running the ball.
Yep. And Ingro, hey, put it in, I think put it in his hands right now. Running, throwing.
Oh, what a sack. What a sack inside. That's David Stewart. All of a sudden, number 29 has showed up here in the second half.
Yep. I tell you what, right now, Springford's on their heels. They're not sure what they want offensively. There's a replay. Oh, coming from the backside. Nobody picked him up.
Well, they got a whole bunch of receivers out this way. They're going to empty backfield. Four wide here, one wide on the other side to see if they go to the one-on-one coverage. They're going to run the fade route out there, and it's just overthrown.
Wow, fourth down.
Fourth down and about 15 now, 16 maybe. And Chad Brubaker's got to punt it. He's got to punt it.
Yep.
Well, you know, you talk about that all-important momentum, Scott. How many times this year have we talked about it? And I'll tell you right now, the orange shirts, or the orange pants, orange helmets, the orange guys have got momentum. I was going to say, they better cover that wide out over there. They got a gunner that nobody's on. Okay, let's see what they do here.
Nice.
Wow, just what they needed. Oh, man.
I told you he could punt the ball.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. And they're going to go half the distance.
Four.
I guess a block in the back. I'm not sure. I'm having a hard time reading the striped shirts this year. I can't even say.
I'm not sure, Dave. I didn't see what happened
there. Yeah,
there
wasn't even a run back attempt on it.
Isaiah was getting away from the ball.
Like I said, I'm having a hard time with the striped shirts this year. I can't quite figure them out. We've had a lot of good football games that have been interrupted by calls that they're going to call pushing the back for PV. All right, here we go. Well, now they're going to have to go the whole length of the field. As I said to you earlier, I said, that just gives me five more yards to give it to Scotty Glenn so he can go 95.
To get over 100 for the night.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
Block in the back.
Well, here we go.
Nice. One to return,
now,
please.
Now, you know,
half the distance to the goal.
Listen. Yeah, let's make
that first down.
PV to do something.
Let's see what happens here now. 5:03 to go. We're all knotted up at 20. We got the two best teams in the Liberty Division fighting for the right to play for the championship at Pottsgrove next Friday night. And I'll tell you what, not one person has left the stands in this game. Look at this.
Yes.
Look at Jake Sturm.
He's gone.
Look
he could be
gone. Look at Sturm. Jake Sturm. Wow.
Yeah, and here it is. It's just up the middle. I think it was a trap. Sturm showing some speed in the open field. That's a nice job by Sturm, willing not to go out of bounds.
Okay, this is starting to get really heat up.
Whew. And
this
it gave him some breathing
up,
room, that's for sure.
Well, it's good to see Sturm back on the field there.
Yeah,
he was injured a little bit earlier and was able to get back out there. As now PV is in the plus side here. They're in Springford territory. They're going to go back to Sturm.
Sturm again, yeah.
Sturm again picks up a couple
of extra. And they got time, Dave. It's not like they have to be in a hurry. They have plenty of time.
You mentioned Springford is the one who's sort of walking around now with their hands on their hips and stuff.
They're
the ones
on their
that are tired
right
now.
Yeah. They're on their heels.
Yeah.
You see the life
PV's
offensive
line some credit right now as they are starting to impose their will on Springford. There's Moshe going to the outside. Does he have a crease? He's got a crease. He's close to it. Oh, he's got another first down.
And this is just Johnny Moshe getting to the corner. Great block out in the perimeter. Again, receiver's doing a great job.
Well, we talked about it. You want to have long runs. Your receivers have to at least screen and get in the way of the defensive backs. As Coach Heist is trying to dial something else up here with 4:16 to go in this ball game. We're all knotted up at 20 apiece. First and 10, ball on the 27.
Be patient, be patient.
They wanted that screen. Okay. Well, the spring forward did an
excellent
job. Great job of reading that screen route. And Kohler did a better job of not throwing the ball recklessly away.
And there we are. And again, this is just a great pass rush. And you're right. They tried to set the screen up. Somebody jumped the running back. Great job.
Yeah. Spring Ford did a nice job reading their keys there. As you know, we talked about Rob Heist loves the screen game. Tried to go to it there, but Spring Ford was ready
well
for it.
Well defended.
Good defensive call by Jimmy Mick and his staff. Boy, now we got second in a mile. There's an out route. Oh, just off the hands of Austin Rowley. Rowley is usually a sure-handed guy, but that was just out of his reach.
Yeah, and a little throw. That was low.
Yeah,
that was low.
Just
he
out of his reach.
Yep.
Even still, even if he makes that catch, he's not able to run much with it.
But it would have made it a manageable third down for him, like a third and 10 maybe. You're looking at a third and 20 right now.
Well, we'll see. These are
two downs,
I used to love when I was coaching on this one, I'd look at Danny. Danny would look at me and say, who's making this call on third and 20? They're not fun. Third and 21.
Sturm is running with passion right now.
He certainly is. He's fired up.
Yeah. And again, you know, maybe he knew this run was coming. Yeah. And wow, he's just making people, he's running over people right now, Jacob.
Are they going to try a field goal from here?
No.
What are they going to do? Yeah, that field goal kicker's out there. Basil's out there. Basil's out there.
Yep.
This is from 33. It's going to be a 43-yarder. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. What happened here? What happened?
43-yard attempt. A seal whistled
in. Come on, guys. Let's figure it out. Are they going to call what? Illegal procedure. False start.
Dead ball.
Yeah.
False start.
Illegal
on the offense. 5 yard penalty.
Fourth
down.
Now, that's right. That's.
Huh. Now, this is what the coach gets paid the big bucks for now.
Now, Dave, nobody's near the guy.
Yeah,
the
now
no,
everybody's walking away from Rob Heist now.
It's all yours, coach.
Boy, what an exciting high school football game. I wish everybody could see the crowd, the student body, the bands. Everybody's having a great time here tonight. This is the way high school football should be. We're having a Donnybrook down here in Royersford, Coach McNally Stadium. We'll see what the young freshman can do here. He's got some time. He's going down into double coverage. Oh, no, they're going to call pass interference.
Yep, they threw the flag, interference.
Pass interference. They double covered Isaiah Domini.
I don't know if it's enough for first down, though, Dave, is it?
Well, it'll at least set up a fourth and
fourth
one.
And a fourth and one.
Yeah, or maybe
you're right.
Even a chance for a field goal then. You know, we'll see what happens.
And it's Kohler was going there all the way.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
They can't.
Well, I tell you, it's tough. I tell you, you know, it's the hardest position to play.
Let him play.
I agree.
Should have let him play.
It's so hard to play defensive back in today's world. Yeah. It really is. And like I said, those spring forward defensive backs have played well all night.
They
really have.
They really have. They're going to have to measure this, Dave. This is close.
And I think if he's short, are you going to go for it?
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah. Oh, yeah. No doubt.
So you're not going for the field goal?
I'm going for it.
Okay. I like when the moms start to yell. When the moms start to yell, that's great. I love it.
They got a
first down. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Well, now they can even choose some more clock up too.
Yeah, take your time.
Oh, man, I'll tell you what. Shoo.
Put yourself in the spot for that field goal.
Boy, who the fuck this about 20 minutes or so ago? You know, it looked like Springford was going to really have this game in hand. Yep. And all of a sudden, next thing you know, is a penalty here, a turnover there, and boom, we got ourselves a heck of a football game.
Well defended. Springford had that well defended.
Well, and they're also, they look to me like they're trying to get it in the middle of the field for that field goal. You know, I never like to let the game come down to a field goal kicker. But I tell you right now, Mr. Basil, what is he? He's a young sophomore.
Yes,
yet?
He's a sophomore.
He's a young sophomore.
Plays soccer. Oh, my God. Soccer player coming
in. Oh, my God. Well, we're going to take a timeout where there's a timeout on the field. It's 2020. We'll be right back.
Yakalak Construction, serving the Tri-County area since 1946. Family-owned, free estimates, all types of concrete work, sidewalks, foundations, steps, curbs, and more. Professional service and quality. Give them a call, 610-323-8134.
Well, let me set up the situation for you, Scott. There's 2 minutes to go. It's first and 12 from the 20-yard line. The score is tied at 20-20. This is for all the marbles in the Liberty Division for a chance to play Pottsgrove. Doesn't get any better than this. Does not get any better than this.
Overtime, Dave.
Look at John Mosha! Look at John Mosha! He's in! John Mosha! As they try to go right up the middle to keep everything going, John Mosha with a touchdown with 1:54 to go.
That's incredible blocking up front, too, Dave. They opened the hole for Johnny Mosha to get in there. That was an incredible line blocking.
Second effort after that first initial
hit.
About the offensive line? You said Coach Heist was a little worried about them because they're a little nicked up.
Right.
And, boy, they came out here in this fourth quarter.
There's people on their backs. And Johnny Mosha, you're right. Look at this. This is just effort to get to them.
And the kick is good. That all-important kick. There's the young sophomore, Basil. Wow, 27-20 as PV jumps out in front. Special thanks to, Matt Miller. Oh, that's Gus Kellis, my bad. Director. Assistant director, Matty Wagner. My main guy on Monday nights. Graphics by Adzor. Garrett Wildgus. My all-name team. Davey Oxenford, our good friend. John Schlegel, helping out on camera. And my girl, little Livy down there, Livy Prothero. Back to the action here as the kickoff is brought back to the 30-yard line. And stats, Jim Kelly. Jim Stats Kelly.
And again, 1:46, Dave. Time enough for Springford to take this down the field.
Well, Springford's offensive line has got to give Engros some time here now. Empty set backfield. It's this ring, Engro. Quick slot outside, and that ball scoops up,
skipped.
Incomplete. Again, Engro takes a shot
and
at the end of the play.
Pressure. Yeah, backside pressure coming. Yep, and Lingo, I think Lingo's coming from the backside here. Yeah, but again, he had time to throw. He had his time to throw that.
Second and 10. Trips out to the far side. They like Baker down the seam here. There he is. Oh!
Yeah.
They like him on that play.
Yeah, and he, you know what? If Rowley, if he catches that, he's gone. Rowley's might have missed him.
He's a playmaker.
Yeah,
and a game
he's a playmaker. Ball was down too. The ball was just down a little low.
Excuse me. I think he could feel Austin Rowley right around
there,
him too.
Yep. And you know, right now, that's what I'm telling the secondary for PV. Just don't give up the long one. Keep everything in front.
See if they go after the quarterback here again. Uh-oh. Somebody jump all sides. But we have some movement.
It's going against Springford.
Little illegal procedure against Springford.
Dead ball.
Oh my.
False start. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
Well, PV was doing a lot of jumping around there, and that gets the attention of those offensive linemen. Now they're going empty set. They got five wide. See if somebody stays the spy on Engro because he can bust one. They're going deep. They're going deep.
That was good position.
And good coverage by Washington. Wow. Wow.
And this is the game, Dave, right here. It's fourth down.
Yeah, Engro shows some good arm strength there, but it's well,
but
overthrown.
Again, well overthrown.
And give Washington a lot of credit right there. Yeah. Wow. Well, here we go. 132. He's got plenty of time. He looks down over the middle, and it's incomplete. The pass goes incomplete, and Turd Valley takes over on down. Wow, oh wow, oh wow.
Yeah, and again, I don't think the receiver is looking back, Dave. I mean, he was running, but he wasn't looking back for the ball.
Trying to find that the running back, Steve Brill, down the seam. Well, now this is where you got to be real careful here. You've got to really play smart. 1:27 to go. This has been a heck of a football game, I tell you. You know, I was really fortunate to be involved with the Pottsgrove and PJP game, which was unbelievable. This one is every bit as good as exciting.
Dave, I'm with you. I thought Springford, when it was 20-3, I still thought Springford, this was their game.
Absolutely.
I mean, I'll give it to PV. They hung in there and fought back.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, that big turnover. We talked about not only getting a turnover, but cashing in on it, and boom.
And that's what happened.
And let me tell you something. This young freshman, he's going to be the BMOC. I'll tell you that, man. He is going to be the big man on campus.
You got to give the kid credit for
Absolutely.
Stepping in the way he did here in this type of atmosphere and this type of game.
Well, you know, I think also PV's coaching staff for not getting excited, staying calm and cool.
Good
you know,
point,
Robbie
Dave.
Heist
Very
is a cool dude. He really is.
Very good point.
Wow. Wow, wow, wow. What a football game.
What a turnaround, Dave.
What a football game. This is another one of those games where you hate to see someone lose it.
Yeah.
They both played very, very well, but I tell you right now, we're going to have a replay of the last 2 years, PV and Pottsgrove, next Friday night Coach Penny Packer Field.
Yep.
Wow. Well, that's going to be seven in a row.
Whoa.
Seven in a row for PV after those two tough losses to the Downingtowns. Seven in a row for Robbie Heist's gang. And what a football game.
It was.
And there will be the final buzzer. And the final's going to be 27-20 in favor of the visitors, the two-time defending Pioneer Athletic Conference champion, Perk Yeoman Valley Vikings.
Perk Yeoman Valley 27, Springford 20. Good luck to both teams as they continue the rest of it.
Welcome to the beautiful historic Redding Country Club, now open to the public. Play the same course that Sneed, Hogan, and Hagen played. Designed back in 1923 by renowned golf architect Alex Finlay, the Redding has 18 championship holes. Now, after your round, just stop on by the Patio Grill for delicious food and a nice ice-cold beverage. Why not book your organization's next outing at the Redding Country Club? Hey, and by the way, check out the weekly exciting leagues. It's memorable now at the Redding. For more information, just check out the website, reddingccgolf.com.
Hey, 27-20 is the final here. PV on top of Spring Ford as they earn the right to represent the Liberty Division in the Pioneer Athletic Conference game next week against Pottsgrove. Coach, hey, all I can say is, boy, you guys really, really hung in there.
Yeah, honestly, Dave, I'm not even really sure what to say. After a game like that, I've never really been around anything like that as a player or a coach. I'm just so proud of our kids, and they never gave up. They kept trusting each other. You know, we lost our quarterback there in the second quarter. We brought Ethan Kohler in. He handled his business, and our kids played for him. They made plays. Our defense played outstanding.
Well, it didn't look good there in the second half when it was 20-6. You guys sort of lost momentum. Then all of a sudden you get a big turnover. You cash in on that,
yeah.
And all the momentum started to switch back to your side.
Our defense couldn't have played any better, in my opinion. You know, we put them in a bad position there a couple times, turning the ball over in our own end zone. Can't do that against a team as quality as Springford. But the defense played incredible. They won us this football game without question.
Well, you know, I always said, and I said to Scotty Furman up there in the booth, that, you know, you're always a guy who keeps his composure. You stay calm. Obviously, your calming influence had a lot to do with your freshman quarterback who's thrown into the biggest game that he'll be in a long time,
yeah.
Until next week, but if he has to play. But seriously, he really held his own and did a couple really, really nice things.
I can't say enough about Ethan. He's a smart kid. He's an AP kid. He's one of those kids you ask him to take mental reps, and he actually does it. You know, Cole gets most of the reps during practice, rightly so. He's our starting quarterback, and Ethan's right there watching and learning. Learning and listening. He just did a great job. I'm very proud of him.
Well, Domini and Moshe were two guys I thought were going to be key tonight. I mean, I thought you had to get them going on the offensive end, and obviously they make big plays going down the stretch for you.
Yeah, I mean, John Moshe, that kid, I would take 11 of him every single year. He just does whatever we ask him to do without complaint. He doesn't get the ball as much as he probably should. He just goes about his business, and we ask him to make a play, he makes a play, and he made a great play tonight. Isaiah's been great for us all season.
Well, you know, and last, before I let you get going back to your team, and I appreciate you stopping by, but my guy, the player of the week, Austin Raleigh, really comes up big. He sticks his nose in there. He makes plays, and he makes it fun for being a coach, I'm sure.
Yeah, Austin's 145 pounds, and, man, he plays like he's 210 pounds. He's just a football player. That's the best compliment I think I can give him. He has great intuition. He's around the ball. He just wants to win.
He is. He's the babyface assassin, man. I tell you, I sit beside him in the show, and I can't believe it that he's that tough of a kid, but he really is all heart. Again, congratulations,
Thank
Coach.
You.
Enjoy this one, and we'll see you next Friday night.
Thank you. Appreciate
all
it.
All right. That's Rob Heist, the coach of the Perk Yeoman Valley Vikings. They are the Liberty Division champions, and they will represent the Liberty Division next Friday night at Penny Packer Field in Pottsgrove. All right, Coach, well, we're going to say goodbye to you, and we'll let
Thank
Furman
you.
And I try to take care of the rest of it. But,
you.
Hey, good luck, man.
Scotty, again, I think Coach said it all right there. I mean, it was an amazing game. You and I were looking at each other up in the booth off and on all night. Oh, my goodness, the momentum here, the momentum there. It didn't look good, whatever. But, boy, man, did they hang in there.
And, you know, Dave, you talk about playing all four quarters. That's exactly what Perk Valley did tonight. You know, they didn't give up. They had three bad quarters, but they came back in that fourth quarter. Dave, you and I have coached long enough that you always tell players, keep playing the next play and just keep playing. You don't know what's going to happen or what the results of this game could be.
And again, on the other sideline, you know, Chad Brubaker and his guys got to feel, you know, terrible. You know, they really played well. It looked like they had control of the game. And then all of a sudden, for whatever reason, in the end of the third quarter, beginning of the fourth quarter, they lost it. And it was just tough going for the Rams.
Yeah, you know what? But I think we're still going to hear a lot out of Springford down the road here. That's a very good football team. And again, they're going to go in there and say, hey, we left one slip away. And there's no doubt about it. And I'm not to say that they weren't probably maybe the better football team out here tonight, but I think down the road we're going to hear some noise out of Springford.
Yeah, James Albert really did a heck of a job defensively. And again, we're seeing Ryan Ingro, the young junior, really becoming a all-league caliber football player. But again, it's 27 to 20, a win by 7 points for Perk Valley as again they go on to the championship game. Scott Furman, Dave Ridenour, all the people here at the PCTV Network. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for more right here.